In association with the National Hockey League.
Toronto proud to announce from Zurich, Men's League, Switzerland, Austin Matthews.
The second pick, the Winnipeg Jets are proud to select Patrick Laine.
They are greatness in contrast.
Austin, he's a special player. I don't think you got to look very far to recognize that.
From the middle to the reaches of the rink, it's excellence.
I think Patrick's more of a natural goal scorer.
One June night brought them together, paying dividends in debuts 4 months later.
Really lucky to have him on our team, and it's going to be exciting to see what he can do this year.
Laine, his shot scores! First NHL goal, Patrick Laine!
And Laine, it's split second, he can change a game.
Tonight, they measure against the other. Matthews versus Laine.
You are looking at the first player ever to score four goals in an NHL debut.
One. Versus two.
Patrick Laine, tremendous rookie, had a great debut, a goal and an assist.
Who makes the first statement? Maple Leafs and Jets next on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey.
The Jets, since relocation, have every first-rounder minus Jacob Trouba, who doesn't have a contract, in the lineup. First-ever pick, Mark Scheifele, right there. Toronto counters with five first-rounders on its side. Morgan Rielly, a veteran in this group. Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey from Winnipeg tonight. Just the Leafs' third game of the year. Mike Babcock's kids with three of four possible points. Winnipeg hoping the focus is there on a busy week in that city leading up to Sunday's Heritage Classic. We're stoking the fire. See if we can get some heat from an American against a Finn on the Canadian prairies. Looking forward to this one. Welcome to Hockey Central. I'm Darren Millard, everybody. 4 months after the draft, we finally get first against second in this Wednesday night hockey game. Bring in Elliot Friedman and Doug McLean. And gentlemen, first against second creates expectations. Is that fair?
It's always fair. When you're at the top of the draft, the expectation is you're going to be a game-changing player. And we've seen the ability in both of them to be that. It worked out perfectly for both teams. Austin Matthews was always Toronto's guy, but Laine was a heck of a consolation prize. Doug, I think they're sick and tired of talking about it, but we're just getting warmed up.
Well, it's interesting with young players and how organizations have to handle them. You think about Tavares, you think of Taves, you think of Kopitar. How much pressure was on those players? Different. This is Canada. Toronto, lots of pressure on Matthews because the team's been so bad. He's perceived as the savior. Starts off with four goals. What do you expect? It's going to be turned up. And Laine, hey, Winnipeg need a star as well. You think back to Solani, 76 goals as a rookie. Lots of pressure on both kids, but I think both management teams will be really careful how they handle both these youngsters.
I thought it was great the response after Austin Matthews scores four goals in the NHL's opening night that Patrick Laine comes back with 1-1 in his NHL debut.
I liked his answer when he was asked about it, though. I only care about 2 points. And he wasn't referring to the ones he got, but the ones for winning the game. It's funny. I was joking about voting. People are already joking the Calder's over. If Matthews has any kind of a season this year, after what he did on opening night, the Calder's his. I think that's a little too soon, but I want to see a race.
Laine stays in the mix, playing with Scheifele, playing with Wheeler, two veterans, and he's a pure scorer. His name will be around a long time because of the way he finds the net.
Do you think the two of them look at this game as a measuring stick, playing against each other?
A little bit. There's a thought there. I want to be better than him tonight.
I think Patrick Laine strikes me as the kind of guy, and Matthews too. At the end of the day, winning is all that matters.
Winnipeg Jets against the Toronto Maple Leafs. Playing in Winnipeg has not been kind for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Just one win since the Jets relocated. There's three distinct errors in the Winnipeg Jets' history. The WHA, the NHL, and this version 2.0. And they all come together this week as we bring in Scott Oak. Scott? 16 shots.
Well, Darren, the young stars of the NHL are still trending upwards. The feature matchup here tonight, Laine versus Matthews, as you have pointed out, whether those two want anything to do with it or not. Laine's place in the game speaks to what Winnipeggers have known for over 40 years, that it's a global game. In the mid-70s, the WHA Jets boasted what many believe to be the best line in hockey, the Hotline. Bobby Hull, teamed with two Swedes, Anders Hedberg and Ulf Nielsen, to champion the Euro-Canadian craze that would become a staple of the game. Look closely tonight, and you'll see traces of it here at the MTS Center. Stand by now to hear from PA announcer Jay Richardson.
Legendary members of our hockey history. The Hotline led the Jets to two APCO Cup championships and are recognized as one of the most talented lines in professional hockey history. They were trailblazers, changing the game forever. And tonight, they become the first members of the Winnipeg Jets Hall of Fame. They were magical from the first moment they skated together. 35-year-old Bobby Hull, 24-year-old Ulf Nielsen, and 23-year-old Anders Hedberg simply clicked. And for the next four seasons, the Hotline dominated the WHA, thrilling fans with their skill, speed, and artistry on the ice. Hull joined the Jets in 72, signing a million-dollar contract in a ceremony in Portage in Maine. The addition of Hull legitimized the league and turned the Jets into a powerhouse. Hull would begin an assault on the rest of the league, putting up 51, 53, and 77 goal seasons. In 76-77, Hedberg would score 70 goals, including 50 in his first 50 games. He would finish his time with the Jets in 78 with one more APCO Cup. And Nielsen would score 140 goals and add 344 assists in just 300 games. He's the all-time leader in WHA assists per game. The Hotline would lead the Jets to two APCO Cup titles in 76 and 78. Collectively, the three members of the line in those four seasons together accounted for 655 goals, 905 assists, and 1,560 points in regular season and playoff games combined. He is the 1976 APCO Cup Playoff MVP, the WHA leader in career assists per game, and a two-time APCO Cup champion with your Winnipeg Jets. Please welcome back number 14, Ulf Nielsen. He had five 50-goal seasons with your Jets, including scoring an astonishing 70 goals in only 68 games in 1977. He's a Bill Masterton Trophy winner, a winner of the IIHF Hall of Fame, and a two-time APCO Cup champion with your Winnipeg Jets. Please welcome back number 15, Anders Hedberg. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please turn your attention to the North Rafters and join us in welcoming Bobby Hull, Ulf Nielsen, and Anders Hedberg, the Hotline, to the Winnipeg Jets Hall of Fame.
side of the net to Nilsson. He looks, pass across, Hedlund. He shoots, he scores! The Jets win the Avco Cup. Nilsson in the corner, circles back to the blue line, does a spinorama, moves back, winds up, she scores!
Gets it to Hedlund, takes a shot.
Fakes the shot, goes around to the right side, drops it back to Bobby Hull, over on the left wing, he shoots, beats Brodeur, has 1,000th goal. Pass across Hedlund, he shoots, he scores! Behind the net, centers it up, and Hull scores!
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we now ask that Toronto Maple Leafs alternate captain Leo Komarov and Winnipeg Jets captain Blake Wheeler skate to center ice for tonight's ceremonial face-off. Time for one of the greatest lines in hockey history, the Hotline. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing. Remove your hats and welcome your Winnipeg Jets own Stacey Natras for the singing of O Canada.
O Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all thy sons command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true North, strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for
from the MTS Center in Winnipeg, it's the Toronto Maple Leafs against the Winnipeg Jets. You know, those 70s Winnipeg Jets you've just been hearing about were fast and skilled with Nilsson and Hedberg, the fresh new faces. The 2016 Jets are trying to become the same kind of team. Difference is, so is everybody else in the league. A salute to the past, now a look at the future that is really the NHL's now. This used to be the designated start for Manitoba, James Reimer, who started all but one of the Leafs' game here since the Jets came back into the league. But Frederik Andersen is going here tonight, and he hasn't lost against Winnipeg. In fact, he won a couple of playoff games here amongst his 4-0 record against the Jets. Used to be Andre Pavlik start too, but he's in the minors as the Jets go young in goal. Michael Hutchinson of Barry starts tonight as he rotates so far with Connor Hellebuck. Not only getting young with the teams, but there's two young men refereeing tonight. Tom Chybelski from Colorado Springs is just 40 games into his NHL refereeing career working with Dan O'Rourke. And Brandon Garlis from Trail BC is working with veteran Kyle Murchison, and this game is underway. And number one and two are on the bench to start, probably by design, so that the coaches don't get involved in the hype. Sean Mathias, former Leaf, in with a shot. Big rebound. Toby Enstrom couldn't corral that. Finally gets a shot, but there's another rebound. Nazem Kadri on a line here with Milan McCulloch. And Leo Komarov dumps the puck in and starts a change for the Maple Leafs. As Brandon Tanev, one of the four rookies in the Jets lineup, stripped to the puck by Tyler Bozak. There's a hard shot by Van Riemsdyk as he leaned into one. Initially, the puck bounced away from Mitch Marner, who's the third member of the line. Tyler Myers is hurt. He's slow to get to the bench and just barely getting one leg over the bench now.
You know, it looked like a shoulder for sure. Myers got tied up there as he turned the puck over and fell heavily on the one shoulder.
Blake Wheeler on the top line for the Jets, and after the puck couldn't get to it. Here's Bozak looking for Mitch Marner, who had some room. He just came over and just about stole the puck from Mark Scheifele. Now there's going to be a penalty. Laine got tripped up, and it's Mitch Marner who's going to get the penalty as Laine made the turn, and Marner got his stick in, and Wheeler gets a shot. Big rebound. Josh Morrissey, number 44, another of the rookies, couldn't quite get a shot away, and he had some net to shoot at. Been a couple of big, juicy rebounds off Frederick Anderson early in the game. So the goaltender is out for the extra attacker, a delayed penalty call against Toronto. Nikolai Ehlers to Matthew Perreault. He just about got his head taken off by Connor Carrick. And they stare at each other as the penalty's finally called.
Well, lots happening here early on, and Tyler Myers still on the bench. That's a good sign for the Jets. Here's the turnover that happened with Tanev, and just an odd play by Myers as he went in quickly to Bozak, had trouble going off, so it didn't look like his shoulder. He just got a stick, lost his wind a little bit, and then back the other way. Neutral zone penalty, something you never want. Just a little hack right on the back of the legs of Wheeler. Down he goes, and Marner spends 2 minutes in the penalty box.
And what that means is that number one, Matthews, doesn't get into the game, and number two, Laine already is, and he's got the only power play goal for the Jets. They win the draw. Adam Lowry got it. Toby Enstrom. There's Laine, number 29. The 18-year-old has one goal on the power play, and he got it from that spot that he likes to park at the top of the left circle. Zach Hyman killing the penalty. He's got Connor Brown with him. Two of the Leafs rookies. They have six in the lineup. Nikolai Ehlers isn't a rookie, but he's still a very young player. He gets the puck in deep. Laine is there. Adam Lowry is the center, number 17. Around the outside to Ehlers and back the other way, Laine. Kyle Connor with him as well. Very young power play anchored by Toby Enstrom. Ehlers tried to go back to the point. Brown blocked that with his skate. Ehlers again centering into another skate. Hyman blocked that. Puck doesn't get out. Toby Enstrom on the other side. His Laine shoots. Missed the net, and the puck comes all the way to the point. Ehlers did a nice job to keep it in. Al Connor out of the University of Michigan. 19 years old. Looks towards the net, looking for his first. Back to Laine. Cross ice pass to Ehlers. Good looking power play, but they haven't been able to get inside. Now Enstrom fires a shot, a missile that went just wide of the net. Laine from the other side. That went off the goaltender Anderson. Laine trying to keep the puck in. Finally chopped out to center. That's a minute and a half of pretty good pressure.
Yeah, it's a good confident power play. There's times when you don't score and it takes all your momentum and energy out, but that was a pretty effective passing sequence there. A couple of good chances at the net.
Great moves by Mark Scheifele to get to the blue line, and then he went over it offside. First five shots of the game have gone to Winnipeg.
Now you see Laine on the bench there talking. As the one thing you'll try to set up with him on the power play is that quick release and hard shot. He ended up getting one on the net there with some traffic in front, but you know that as the year goes along, the power play will start to be working towards getting that one-timer or quick wrister off the left side.
Craig, this should be the first power play unit, but the second one did such a nice job. These guys barely get into the game. We're into the power play as Matthew Perreault gets in. He's got Stafford with him, and Blake Wheeler, who scored in all three games, and Scheifele, and Dustin Byfuglien. What a great backhand pass. Scheifele delays, hard pass across. Wheeler shoots. He hit his own man, Stafford, in front of the net. And the puck is cleared down the ice.
Well, one thing early on, Toronto's really tried to be aggressive on their penalty kill, but those quick passes make it so difficult for the pressure to continue for the Leafs. And Winnipeg gets two good chances, and that one for Stafford couldn't get out of the way as he was in front making the screen.
It was a hard shot. So back to 5-on-5. The Leafs haven't had a shot on goal yet, but there's a big turnover, and it might come here. Jake Gardner, Komarov's trip to the side of the net, no call. Gardner gets in deep. He's watched by Wheeler. Komarov trying to get his stick away from Tyler Myers, who's back in the game. Nikita Zaitsev puts the puck in deep. Mikolic is there with Kadri and Komarov. Bumplin in some trouble against the forecheck of Mikolic. Wheeler late in his shift. Here's Scheifele trying to break away to the net. And he shoots, and Anderson makes the save. Kadri was in pursuit of forward, and what a good shift for Scheifele, or a good burst of speed at the end of a long shift.
Yeah, the end of a long shift is difficult as a defenseman. Gardner was thinking offense here. They had good pressure, goes for the pinch, and just a little bit of a delay. He thought he had maybe a little bit more support, but a nice job of Kadri coming back and making sure that he didn't allow Scheifele an easy entry, didn't allow him to cut across, and a nice save by Anderson early.
Not much he could do with that rolling puck either. No. A good start for Winnipeg here. Good power play, just didn't get them a result. There's Austin Matthews, finally gets a chance to get into the game. Just about a big giveaway there. Matthews, William Nylander, and Zach Hyman on this forward line, playing against Adam Lowry. With Brandon Tanev, Sean Mathias. Here's Tanev with a shot. That's deflected into the corner. I think that went off Marincin, the defenseman in front, as Tanev looked for his first NHL goal. He's out in front of the net alone once again. Back to the blue line, Ben Sherratt. Can't go D to D, goes to the side of the net. There's a loose puck up for grabs. Lowry's trying to get a hold of it, and he does, and plays it back. Sherratt again, just onside, keeps the puck in for Sean Mathias. Cycles back. Joel Armia in the midst of a Winnipeg change. Armia. Here's somebody calling. It was Sherratt who got the puck at the point on the other side. Paul Postma kept the puck in. The Jets are playing keep away. There's another shot that went off the skate. 7-0 of the shots now. The Leafs have barely touched the puck. Armia for Bistrup. This Leaf line has been trapped in its own end, and they finally get out. And not enough for icing, so that's good news for them.
Yeah, the Matthews line in their first shift sat and watched as the power play of the Jets went on and then spent the whole first in their own zone.
The Jets have really been skating well to start the game, haven't they? Up the boards, a turnover. Gardner to the front of the net. That's tipped wide of the goal. Connor Carrick. James Van Riemsdyk. Bozak, Mitch Marner's in front of the net. And the puck comes loose off the boards. An errant pass trying to get it back to Carrick at the point. Marner gave the puck away, and the Jets were able to get it out. Now they finish a change, or trying to. Van Riemsdyk with a shot off the toe of Hutchinson. That should be the first shot on goal. 6.5 minutes in, another turnover. Marner, Van Riemsdyk, rebound, Carrick scores! Connor Carrick on the rebound of a Van Riemsdyk shot, and against the flow of play, the visitors have a 1-0 lead.
And it's about taking advantage of turnovers in the neutral zone as the Jets try to make a change here. Everybody on the back end thinks that the puck's going to go deep. Instead, it's turned around. Now you're chasing the game. One good chance there by Van Riemsdyk, a chance to get it out of the boards that doesn't make it, and Van Riemsdyk with the hard shot that Hutchinson, you could see, was sliding to his right in desperation, couldn't get back. Heads-up play, though, coming in from the point by Carrick and making sure he got inside position on Bufflin. And it's not the number of shots, it's the quality of ones. And that one, a wide-open net for Carrick.
So they hadn't had a shot for just over 6 minutes. They got three in a row. The third one went in the back of the net. Carrick from James Van Riemsdyk and Mitch Marner. At 6:44, the first goal of the game. There's another big turnover. Kadri to his forehand, stopped by Hutchinson. And the rebound's gobbled up by Matthew Perreault to center, out of the reach of Ehlers. Matt Hunwick is back. Thought it was going to be icing. No call on that. Might be at the other end as the puck goes off the boards. And no icing there either. This is Josh Morrissey, hit hard and taken out by Leo Komarov. Zaitsev with a shot, bouncing in the air. Big hit by Komarov on Josh Morrissey. And that means the Leafs still have the puck. Kadri, Zaitsev jumps in from the blue line. Matt Martin in the midst of a change. Connor Brown is with him in front of the net. Taking over here is Big Buff, number 33, Dustin Bufflin, and he flips the puck down the ice, needing a change. Zaitsev trying to take advantage to Connor Brown. Puck went through his legs. He couldn't touch it. It's an icing call against Toronto.
Well, a tough play for Michael Hutchinson here. He's been sitting watching his team in the offensive zone for the first 6 minutes, and then suddenly twice Toronto Maple Leafs get behind the defense. An excellent save there. No chance in the rebound, but I'm sure early on, Jim, Paul Maurice won't be happy with the amount of turnovers that have happened in the last 3.5 minutes. One of them there resulting in a goal.
Yeah, give them, have such a good start and then give a couple away.
You see the importance of that early penalty kill for the Toronto Maple Leafs, something that last year they didn't fare too well in early in games. Giving up those early goals was a killer for them.
Lowry won the faceoff. Toby Enstrom from Myers. Hard cross ice pass, too hot to handle for Sean Mathias, the former Leaf. Enstrom stays in deep. Adam Lowry's pin. Brandon Tanev. Vancouver Canucks, Chris's brother. Lowry. Mathias trying to get open. This line's had a couple of good shifts, and Mathias takes over on this cycle. Tanev throws the puck towards the net. It's up for grabs. Mathias got there first against Zaitsev. Turns back again, stripped to the puck, and finally the Leafs get it back. Matt Martin starts out, but an errant pass will turn it back to Winnipeg. Driven in by Toby Enstrom. Matt Hunwick. Winnipeg changing a little time here along the boards. Nylander, though, is stripped to the puck, and it stays in for Mistra. Armia, with some room, took a shot, and the stick of Hunwick deflected that into the corner. Nylander throws the puck out to center. Zach Hyman is after it. Austin Matthews is there as well. Nylander's pass knocked down. Kyle Connor in after the puck, has some support there as Bufflin fell and accidentally kept the puck in. Jake Gardner weaves to center. Hard cross ice pass, Nylander. Matthews shot it just wide, trying to bank the puck back out front. Hyman throws it back to the blue line, and that came outside.
I think Matthews was more surprised than anybody, Jim, that he ended up alone and with the puck.
Yeah, once again, a Leaf alone in front of the net.
Yeah, the sea just parted there for him. He walked right in.
Game's being played at a pretty fast pace, isn't it?
As we expected. He's talked about the youth and the speed of both of these teams. You've seen it here early on.
Morgan Rielly, Matt Marinson, Martin Marinson. They've become, early in the season, looks like they're being groomed to be the shutdown pair playing against all the top lines, and they're out against Scheifele's group here. Tyler Myers under pressure from Komarov. Turned the puck over again. Here's Kadri to the net. Steered wide. He had Peter right on him. Couldn't get a shot. Centering pass and a quick shot off the heel of the stick of Milan McCulloch. Didn't get the shot he wanted, and he looked skyward in frustration. Michael Hutchinson holds on. Leafs have the first goal. Connor Carrick's first of the season on Scotiabank Wednesday night hockey. 1985, you were number two to Wendell Clark's number one. You remember playing him for the first time, and did it mean anything to you?
Absolutely it did. I think you're always tied to the guy who goes ahead of you. I think it's one that you try to judge your game against the other. For me, Wendell Clark had such a great rookie season, 34 goals for the Toronto Maple Leafs. I had 11. And it's a frustrating time. You're always marked and measured against the two. And I think the first one is special. For me, Jim, that first game we played against the Maple Leafs, I got my first assist. The second game, got my very first goal the next night. So Wendell won the year. But it's something that I think you always try to focus on, beating the guy who went above you. I love the personality, too. Laine's got that edge to him that it'll be interesting. You almost feel like Austin Matthews is never going to say anything wrong.
If he is excited about this night, he's not.
He's not showing
it,
that's for sure. Whereas Laine this morning was pretty animated, and you just always wonder what's going to come out of his mouth. I don't mind that.
False start on the faceoff here. So Toronto went 6 minutes and 36 seconds into this game before they got the first shot on goal. And at 6:44, they got the first goal of the game. Tyler Bozak The battle on the faceoff, and the Jets won the loss there. Perreault got the puck out to center. Drew Stafford took the faceoff. We'll have to be creative on faceoffs with this team without Brian Little, who's a veteran faceoff man who takes most of their draws when he's in the lineup. Stafford to the blue line. Paul Postma walks the line and shoots off a skate right to Frederik Andersen, and he stops play.
Right, for Paul Maurice here in a game that you know is going to be emotional. You heard him with Scott Oak before the game talk about their last, despite a loss against the Bruins, was their best game of the three. And this is going to be a teaching process with such a young group. But you know, on home ice, this has got to be a tough building to come into and get points out of. They need to continue to grow as a young group and make this a difficult spot to win.
Bistrup had become a winger. He's back at center. Peter Holland beat him on the draw. And so the Leafs are able to get out to center. Bistrup and Matthew Perreault both moving back into the middle. Here's another turnover. Holland in front for Martin. Probably should have shot it. The Jets have had some great play early. Hunwick takes a shot deflected wide, but they've shot themselves in the foot here a couple of times. Only had to pay for it once. Connor Brown battles along the boards. To the blue line, Hunwick with a wrist shot. Blocked in front of the net by Sherratt. Holland comes in after the puck and threw it to the front of the net. Sherratt takes over again. Glass, not out. Zaitsev kept the puck in. Could Matt Martin hold it into the line? Yes, he did. Holland trying to drag it inside on Postma and can't. And Connor gets the puck to center. Bermistrov late in his shift, fires one off the glass. Both teams will change. Fast pace first. Already 11 and a half minutes gone in it. Here's Austin Matthews, lost the puck. Scheifele takes it, and that went off the toe of his stick and wide of the net. Puck's thrown at the net, Zaitsev blocked it. Laine and Matthews on the ice at the same time here. Hyman to center, Nylander with it. Little chip and chase. Josh Morrissey, first man back. Going back to the blue line, Morgan Riley couldn't handle the puck. He has to turn in a hurry because Blake Wheeler's right there. Wheeler, Laine, and Scheifele, the top line for Winnipeg, all three of them right-handed. There's an icing call against Toronto, so a break in the action, and we have a look at our keys to the game for Tim Horton's official coffee of the NHL.
Well, the goal crease is wide open for the Winnipeg Jets with Pavlik in the minors, and to this point, neither one of these two goaltenders for Paul Maurice has been able to take advantage of the crease. And these Leafs, with three games and four nights with a young team on the road, show that poise and confidence to get through the rough stretches, which they did early in this game.
Yeah, a little poise and confidence early in the game. Good penalty kill, not any shots, but weathered the storm, got a couple of big saves, and then the first goal, and there's an icing call now against Winnipeg.
Well, I think what you notice, too, is the structure. You think of Mike Babcock teams, whether he's coaching the World Cup, the Olympics, or now with this team, is trying to have that structure in all three zones. And early when the pressure was on, the Jets had them running around a little bit in their own zone, but they kept them to the outside, and they didn't overreact or over-pursue.
Perreault won the draw against Kadri, and Kadri's been hard to beat in the faceoff in the first couple of games. 20 of his first 29 draws. Here's where the problem has been for Winnipeg in this period, right around that blue line where they've turned the puck over a couple of times.
You mentioned Kadri too, Jim. That's one way of staying in the lineup and getting some ice time, isn't it? You can improve in that area. Mike Babcock will put you in those situations in your own zone.
He's very demanding about faceoffs. He thinks everybody should be able to win them. He has the spare goaltender keeping track of that sort of thing. Because of that, even this young team is over 50% in the faceoff circle. They haven't shown the problems that youth usually brings you in the faceoff circle.
I think Babcock's feeling is that it's a learned talent, and you can spend lots of time. You can do video and tape and practice every day to improve.
Jets get this draw. Here's Bufflin with a hard shot, went off something or somebody and landed on the back of the net off the glass, so play is stopped. Connor Carrick's got the only goal of the game. The Maple Leafs in Winnipeg have a 1-0 lead on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey.
siege by the media, everyone hoping he would ignite the Laine Matthews matchup tonight, but the Finnish rookie would not play along. So then over to Matthews, with whom there was no chance of inciting a controversy, even when the questions got down to the Jets franchise moving to his hometown of Phoenix in 96, a year before Matthews was born, although he was well acquainted with that history. So two prized rookies playing it smart, even if neither wants to be outdone by the other tonight, Jim.
And Matthews is 19 going on 34.
Yeah, the way he talks.
Patrick Laine a little more excitable, but you're right, wouldn't take the bait. Here's Josh Morrissey off the draw. That went off a leg. Bufflin with a quick shot. Another block. Milan McCulloch got that. Sean Mathias trying to get a hold of the puck. Nazem Kadri turns on his forehand. Morgan Riley looking for McCulloch. Just got the puck to center. McCulloch then advances it. And Morrissey is back. Interesting pair with Morrissey, 44. 33 is Dustin Bufflin. Both of them can get up and go. Bufflin over to the boards to get the puck. Brandon Tanev stripped to the puck. Zaitsev starts out. Kadri took a hit, but he got the puck off the boards. Scheifele at center for Bufflin. Back in for Morrissey. It was just behind him. And a delayed offside, but the Jets tag up. Jets had the first seven shots on goal in the game. The Leafs have had the next six. Centering pass from Marner. Marinson fires a shot. Didn't miss by much up high with traffic in front. And a puck got up in the air and hit Tyler Bozak in the side of the head. He's got to get to the bench. Scheifele and Wheeler in with the puck. Laine is with him. Scheifele's over on the other side. And the Leafs come back. Tyler Myers then takes over and sends Toronto back into its own zone. Martin Marinson off the boards to center. The puck stolen by Joel Armia. Morgan Riley steps up and dumps the puck in. Connor Brown in on the fly. Runs into Morrissey. Connor Carrick is pinched in from the blue line to help out for Toronto. On the other side, Kyle Connor. Up the boards, not out. Jake Gardner couldn't keep the puck in. Armia did a nice job getting his stick in. And Gardner went down, did a barrel roll, and no penalty call. And the play is stopped with the puck out of play. Puck was very much in play when it hit Tyler Bozak in the side of the head. Looks like he's going to be okay on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey. Started giving it up.
Yeah, the turnover train started going the way of the Winnipeg Jets, and it just allowed the Toronto Maple Leafs some easy offense, some spread between the forwards and the D, some misplays, some good aggressive forecheck, as you see Komarov with the big hit that separates the puck and gets another chance. And right now for Paul Maurice, it's the message on the bench, just protect the puck, make the simple plays, and out-support your opponent.
Puck's deflected over the glass, out of play. Winnipeg's made six turnovers, Toronto four in the early part of this game.
Well, you think of early on here for the Winnipeg Jets, they've been able to score first, but then they've given up the leads. Their very first game, the 1-0 lead turned into a 4-1 deficit that they had to fight back here. The opposite. They look good early, but they haven't been able to get their offense going.
Had tough second periods in their first three games. But still some time for them to catch up here in the first. Toby Enstrup, watched by Zach Hyman. Matthew Perreault, watched by Nylander. Nylander with a good forecheck. Chases the Jets 200 feet from his goal. That's Nikolai Ehlers with the puck. Long pass by Myers to center. And that's turned back by Matt Hunwick. So the Jets regroup again. Drew Stafford on this line with Perreault and Ehlers. Stafford couldn't take the pass. Marinson poked the puck away, but Ehlers got it. Side of the net for Stafford. Couldn't control the bouncing puck. It clanked off his stick. And out comes Nazem Kadri. He's got McCulloch with him. Stood up nicely by Josh Morrissey, the 21-year-old from Calgary. And the puck goes deep. Morgan Riley right in front. Kadri scores! What a heads-up play by Morgan Riley. And Nazem Kadri has his first goal of the season. 2-0 Toronto.
Now, you mentioned the good play at the blue line, and Morrissey does make the good play, and then a turnover yet again. Perreault loses the battle. Morrissey here does a nice job with his feet, stops his man, but then as he turns to find the puck, thinks that they're going to be going back the other way. Instead, an errant chance. He doesn't get the body position. Bad stick by Perreault to allow that pass. No stick by Morrissey as he misses that, and Hutchinson can't find that puck through the screen. That's a quick release there by Nazem Kadri, and a look of more of the goaltender Hutchinson. He couldn't believe that went underneath him.
That's Kadri's first point of the season. Not to suggest he's played poorly, but he gets a goal there that makes it 2-0.
And he hadn't been shooting, Jim. Just one shot in the first two games. And there, that one surprised him.
Now here's the new NHL, Craig, and the way defense is played now, and all of them have to skate. Morgan Rielly spotted that and flew down into the corner to get the puck.
I think the aggressive pinches, you're right. You join the rush. If you make the play in your own zone, you join it. It looks like the Jets are going to be in good position there. And Perreault just a little bit late. Morrissey loses his gap. But a heads-up play there for the pass.
16-12 the time of the goal. It gives Toronto a 2-0 lead. Think about who the scratches are tonight. Guys like Mark Stewart, solid defenseman. Roman Polak, same sort of thing. But there's a chance in front for Van Riemsdyk and a good stick there by Ben Sherratt.
The young guys who can wheel that are in
the
lineup.
The other guys are becoming endangered species. You got to be able to skate. Riley's one of the best, and he and Marinson, an unlikely top pairing. Maybe very likely now. Here's Wiener. Onto the attack. His pass scooped up by Enstrom. Waits. Protects the puck with that long stick, and he threw the puck off Anderson to the front of the net. Long shot by Laine, wide of the net and off the glass. Sherratt's in deep. Laine's in front. Got the heel of his stick on the puck, but that's all. To the blue line, Enstrom got handcuffed. He was going one way, the puck the other. And now he turns back into his own zone to get it. Brandon Tanev, 24-year-old out of Providence College, stripped of the puck. Back the other way comes Toronto. Breakaway pass gathered in by Holland. And he's stopped by Hutchinson. Big save from Michael Hutchinson, or it's 3-0 Toronto on a breakaway pass after a turnover inside the blue line that time. Good transition for Toronto. Here come the Jets. Sean Mathias snaps a shot up high and missed. Tyler Myers on the other side. In deep from Mathias. Worked over by Nikita Zaitsev. Matthews back, center in support, and the puck deflected off him and bounces up the middle. Kick to the blue line, not out. Jets keep it in. Lowry gathered it in, and Matthews got back again and deflected the puck in behind the net. His pass to Connor Brown. He can't negotiate it at center. Back is Zaitsev. Get the puck from Frederick Anderson. Hit the referee. It's a turnover. Joel Armia centering, and Hunwick blocked that pass that was headed across to Kyle Connor. At the blue line, Bufflin's in some trouble, and he recovered against William Nylander. There'd have been a 2-on-1 there. There's Kyle Connor. Darts into the attacking zone. His pass in front. Bermistrov took that in his skates and couldn't get a shot. Connor again. Bermistrov to the blue line. Bufflin shoots. He fanned on it. And an off-speed shot deflected wide. Last minute of play in a fast-paced first period. Long pass coming off the bench. Enstrom fires a shot. Anderson made the save. He got across, and Enstrom had leaned into it pretty good. Here's Toby Enstrom again. Fakes. Myers takes. That's blocked by Nylander. And a good last shift here for Winnipeg. Kyle Connor passes off again. Bermistrov pinned to the boards. Matthews at the end of a long shift doesn't get the puck out. Myers kept it in. Armia shoots, and Anderson makes the save. And the Leafs needed that whistle with 22 seconds to go.
Well, a really good bounce back by the Winnipeg Jets, as this one could have been 3-0. A turnover just inside the line, a heads-up play by Nylander, and this for Hutchinson. He read the fake, came down, and that's one play, Jim, when you've got a right-handed catching goaltender. That if he makes that play with a left-handed catching one, you might catch the goaltender down and not be able to make that save.
Jets again with a shot by Ehlers that's deflected wide. Myers is in deep, some pressure on here trying to get a goal before the end of the period, but that'll just about do it as the puck comes down to Michael Hutchinson. First period impressive start for the Winnipeg Jets, but the Leafs got the only two goals, Connor Carrick and Nazem Kadri. Coming up in our first intermission, get to know Patrick Laine a little bit better. Right now, let's go to Darren Millard.
Here in a moment, Elliot Friedman is going to check in with an update on Andre Pavlich. He's been demoted to the American Hockey League by the Winnipeg Jets, but there may be movement to come there. But first, the big story tonight, Austin Matthews and Patrick Laine drafted together in Buffalo, together again tonight, but on opposite sides.
From my perspective, since I've been the Leafs coach, that's the best night I've had since I've been here by 10 miles.
Pollock trying to get untangled, puck goes around, Matthews scores!
His hockey abilities kind of speak for themselves, so he's got pretty much the whole package.
He's definitely got talent, and, you know, I mean, he was picked number one for a reason.
Oh, great work. He gets free. Shoots, scores. What a goal.
I mean, he's a special player. I don't think you got to look very far to recognize that.
Puck out in front. Matthews scores. A hat trick. Oh, my goodness. What a debut.
I don't think people realize how good his little details are. Stops at the net, defensive positioning, the way he gets under people's hands.
Steals it off of Erik Karlsson. Walks in, thank you very much.
Very humble, very smart, respectful, great kid.
You know, he's got a Taze, a Crosby, a Bergeron drivetrain. He wants to be that good, which I really like.
Nylander moving in, puts it across in front, he scores!
Matthews is more of a, you know, puck's on his stick, he's controlling the game, and in Laine, it's, you know, a split second, he could change a game.
Back for Enstrom for Laine.
He can come in and he can just score goals. That's something that, you know, we need. There aren't many guys I've played with or played against who can shoot it like he can.
They expect big things from this young man.
He jumps off the page with the things he can do out there.
Laine has it again. Cross ice, Wheeler, and score!
He's a good passer. He reads the ice well. He's a good skater.
He's got some abilities that guys just don't have.
He's got some good hands, so I think he's going to be a pretty special player.
He's brought the MTS Center to its feet. Toronto proud to announce from Zurich, Austin Matthews.
Number one is a big deal. Welcome to the NHL.
Appreciate it.
You're a very confident young man. We've spoken to you a couple of times, and that shines through. Did Toronto make a mistake?
I'm not going to say anything about that. They didn't take me, so that's fine. And I'm just super happy to be part of Winnipeg now. It's good to have those things to the audience, and they can speculate in it, who is better or something like that. But I just want to focus on my job, which is playing hockey in this team. So, and Austin can do what he ever wants to do in Toronto.
There's enough expectation on him to start with. You know, he's an 18-year-old kid, got taken second overall, playing in the Canadian market, and a very small Canadian market at that.
He's a great kid. He wants to learn. He wants to be a better hockey player. He wants to, you know, pick everyone's brain, and that's, you know, awesome for a young guy.
He reminds me of Steven Stamkos. He's going to be a special player for this Winnipeg Jet organization.
Incredible. A quiet first period for both guys, but over 6 minutes of ice time here with Doug McLean and Elliot Friedman. But a week into your NHL career, and you've got this signature game, and it's all about you.
Yeah, and that's all we've talked about all week, is going into Winnipeg, Austin Matthews versus Laine. And whether they're first overall picks or whatever, there's a lot of pressure on them. There's a ton of pressure going head-to-head, still early in your career. Yeah, they didn't get a lot done. A couple of shots. Matthews had one shot where he threw it from the side. A couple of giveaways. But a nondescript period, but they're 18-year-olds, and you still are glued to them every time they step on the ice. I'm watching Matthews, I'm watching Laine, expecting the unexpected from both of them.
After an opening game win, the Winnipeg Jets dropped two straight and are behind 2-0 tonight against the Toronto Maple Leafs. They don't have the Jacob Trouba thing settled yet. Andre Pavlich was sent to the minors. Now, Arizona has a goalie go down last night, Mike Smith. We know what's happening in the with the LA Kings. Any possible movement there?
I think the LA Kings in particular are considering a lot of different options in goal. Dean Lombardi said today that Jonathan Quick will be out approximately 3 months with his injury. There's a couple of different things they're looking at. One of them is Andrei Pavlik, and the biggest problem with Pavlik is his cap hit is $3.9 million, and they would need Winnipeg to help them in order to make this move happen. Another goaltender is in the same situation as Steve Mason, $4.1 million. UFA after this year, a lot of history between Ron Hextall and Dean Lombardi. I think they've talked about it, but again, I'm not sure they can happen. This, I think, is a more possible scenario for LA. It's Rhett Obera. He's making $1.45 million. He's in the minors with Luongo and Reimer there. I think that's a move LA could make if they want to. I think another possibility could be Mike Condon once Matt Murray is back to health in Pittsburgh and he's getting close.
The Winnipeg idea of helping out the LA Kings just puzzles me a little bit because that could be one of those crossovers and meet in the playoffs, the team that you're battling with for a playoff spot. Time for What's the Call from Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey. In a game on Sunday between the Islanders and the Ducks, Cal Clutterbuck breaks a stick, kicks the puck to John Tavares, who pots his own rebound for the goal. But while kicking the puck, Clutterbuck is still holding his broken stick. So we ask you, is this a goal or no goal? Visit sportsnet.ca/whatsthecall to have your say. We'll have the answer after the break on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey on Sportsnet. Showed you Cal Clutterbuck breaking his stick, kicking the puck to John Tavares for a goal while holding his broken stick. So was it a good goal or a no goal? The call on the ice was goal, and playing the puck with a broken stick is not reviewable. So this is the inner workings of it. If the referees had seen Clutterbuck play with a broken stick, play should have been stopped, no goal, he would have been assessed a minor penalty. So if you said no goal, you're wrong, but technically you're right. Scott Oak with Mark Scheifele in Winnipeg.
Mark, it was almost as though you played two games in one in the first period. You buzzed the Leafs early, then started turning the puck over. How would you explain it?
Yeah, we gotta play the right way. It comes down to this, just that. We're all over the place. We're not getting pucks deep behind their D, and it showed. You know, we're turning pucks over at the blue lines, and this team's gonna make us pay.
You're a real student of the game, and a lot of the history of the Jets was on display here tonight in the pregame ceremony honoring the hotline. What did you think of the ceremony?
Yeah, it's awesome. To have such great players here in Winnipeg be honored like that. It makes it pretty special to be able to play in a place like this.
Thank you, Mark. Appreciate your time.
Thank you.
Paul Maurice on his team's defensive play. It's a work in progress. We have the NHL on Sportsnet, the NLCS on Sportsnet 1 and 360. It's 1-0 Chicago, but it might be 0-0. It's under review. This has been a beautiful intermission.
Wilson, or as they were affectionately known their time in Winnipeg, Anderson Ulf, and that's all you had to say, and everybody knew you. Earlier tonight, inducted as members of the hotline, along with Bobby Hull, the inaugural inductees into the Jets Hall of Fame. What's it mean to you?
It means so much. Being here in Winnipeg, the first inductee, there will be lots of good players coming. I don't know who they are, but it feels very good to be part of it.
Ulf. It feels great also to me. I've never been honored like this before, so it's great.
No, I'm not sure if you guys ever thought about it in those 4 years from 74 to 78, but you were revolutionizing the game, and Glenn Sather has been quoted many times as saying he built the Edmonton Oilers to play the way that you guys did with Bobby on the hotline. Have you ever taken the time to think about how you did change the game?
Well, I think the secret in life is surround yourself with great people, and having Anderson, Bobby, yeah, on my side is terrific, really.
Anders?
It's a very nice compliment of Glenn Sather. And in a sense, looking at the game today, the way they've been played with puck possession, yeah, we did actually play with puck possession. That was our secret. And changing positions and delays of the game. Yeah, and we switched from left to right. Yeah, we were. It feels very good, actually.
Okay, quickly, Ulf gets a pass because he's got two new knees and an artificial hip. Why aren't you, Anders, playing in the alumni game on Saturday?
I have Willa Lindstrom, my age, playing for me, and he will do it much better than I could ever imagine doing it.
All right. Great to see you both. Congratulations on tonight's honor, and look forward to seeing you at the Heritage Classic.
Thanks, Scott.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Jim.
Thank you, Scott. They're such a big part of the heritage of hockey in Winnipeg, and you're so right. They were so far ahead of their time. All that skill and all the while dodging punches.
Nazem Kadri has a goal tonight. So does Connor Carrick, and he took a pass from 43. And that was knocked down. Milan McCulloch will hold the puck in for Toronto. Leaders 2-0 in the game. Carrick and Kadri with the goals, and there's Carrick again. Suburban Chicago native into Milan McCulloch. Leo Komarov gets a big hit in along the boards. Big blow on Toby Enstrom. Brandon Tanev to center, dumps the puck in. And Freddie Anderson's out to play it. Austin Matthews had an average shift length of 1:04 in the first period. I'm not sure if his teams would like that, but it's partly due to being trapped on the ice a couple of times. Two long ones.
Yeah, I think there are sometimes you're on a power play that maybe you get a long shift, but that's definitely something that Mike Babcock looks at as the coaching staff. You think of the World Cup, Jim, when top lines were going 30 seconds and getting off, and you don't want to be caught out there long.
Josh Morrissey with a shot. Went wide of the net, hooked to the front of the goal by Wheeler, and he lost control of it. 3-on-2 back through center. That was a great stick by Josh Morrissey to slow up the other 44, Morgan Riley. Now Morgan's got to get back, and he's got plenty of speed to do so. Riley and Marinson playing against Scheifele's line with Liney and Wheeler. Marinson to center, Scheifele back the other way, Morrissey. Jumps up, fires a shot, Anderson gobbles it up. Has been a lot of hostility early in the game, and there won't be much here.
Get the PlayStation 4 bundle now. Play NHL 17, the most exciting EA Sports NHL ever on PS4.
Been a bit like a EA Sports game so far.
Yeah, there's been their share of turnovers and end-to-end action.
Toby Enstrom with a long shot off the faceoff, and another little battle in front of the net.
It's interesting, there hasn't been much of it in this game, and you mentioned Nilsson and Edberg having to deal with the punches back in the old WHA days. There was plenty of that going on. And here, though, I think for the Winnipeg Jets, they need a little bit of emotion. This typically is such a difficult building and loud building to play in, but I think they've been a little bit shocked, and you have the balance with all the Leaf fans here as well.
Leaves Austin Matthews up to center with Hyman and Nylander. Tyler Myers back to get the puck from Michael Hutchinson. Myers watched by Matthews and turned back. A little more speed this time to center. Drew Stafford backhands the puck into the middle of the ice. Ehlers left it for Myers, and he couldn't quite control it. Had a chance to get to the net for a shot. Zaitsev to Austin Matthews. He dangles through the neutral zone, snaps a shot. Hutchinson made the save and smothered the rebound. And it's the first time tonight with the puck on his stick we've seen Matthews get his wheels going.
Yeah, you see the danger when you get some open ice. And Tyler Myers had jumped up offensively, so he's back off the line just a little bit. And at the end, a little pushback there by Myers, and he falls awkwardly into the backboards. But Matthews, when he gets ahead of steam there, you can just see the open ice and the threat. And like you'll see many times, Jim, a little coaching back on the bench every time these two young teams go back to the bench.
Connor Brown with his shot off the faceoff, and that's deflected wide of the net. Jake Gardner for Toronto in deep off the defense. Now he's got to get back. Bermistrov chopped the puck into the middle. There's a chance for a two-on-one, but Connor Carrick got over. Joel Armia, first-round draft pick in 2011 with the Buffalo Sabres, came here in the Kane trade. Postman with his shot, knocked down in front and shot wide by Kyle Connor. And flipped to center by Matt Martin of Toronto. Bermistrov. Sherratt. Long shoot in, slowed up by Anderson. Gardner double teamed along the boards. Armia took the puck away, then lost it in his feet. And Toronto gets a chance to break out. Matt Martin to center. Didn't get the puck deep. Gardner followed up and dumped the puck in. And Leafs change on the fly. Ben Sherratt to center. Kadri's trying to track him down. Komarov cut him off. Matt Hunwick gets the puck. Zaitsev on the other side. Got the pass through to center. Milan McCauley fires a shot. Hutchinson bobbled it with Komarov right there, and that'll get some action in front. Sherratt wanted no part of Komarov getting to the net. But the puck was in the air, and it wasn't held by Hutchinson.
Heads-up play going hard to the net, as you're right. Hutchinson, it looked like, was going to be able to just absorb that one into his chest. Little stretch pass. Again, the D backing off the line creates that shot, but some anxious moments, and then Hutchinson gets a little tap to the head there as Kadri goes by. So often that high shot you can just absorb. See, he thought he had it with his glove and then wasn't able to, and right on target comes Komarov again, going hard to the net.
And he probably would have gone straight to the net
with or without the puck.
Bobbled or not.
Yeah. This is a key period for Hutchinson, too. I mentioned the fact that the crease is open. The guys talked about Pavlik in the minors. This is a chance to prove you can be a number one goaltender in the NHL.
His team's been outscored 6-0 in second periods, and he has to fight through some traffic there to make a save on Martin Marincin. And now the puck is over the glass and out of play. Well, the tradition continues at Investors Group Field in Winnipeg. It's the 2016 Tim Hortons NHL Heritage Classic. The Oilers against Scheifele and the Jets on Sunday at Sportsnet. Forecast looks pretty good right now. 7 or 8 degrees, partly cloudy. Today it would have been tough to play there with the wind blowing the way it was. And you never know, in this city it might be windy on Sunday. Mark Scheifele for the Jets, tracked down at center. Mitch Marner. Marincin bobbled the puck, and he's got pressure right there. Back to the blue line. Josh Morrissey slides into the middle on the other side. Bufflin with a hard pass, missed everybody. Scheifele with his shot, kicked out by Anderson. And bounced to center by Martin Marincin. James Van Riemsdyk. Marner got crunched by Scheifele. He looks like he's all right. Toronto's hanging onto the puck here to get a change in as Marincin dumps the puck in. Hutchinson gave it away. The centering pass by Matthews. Maybe trying to bank one in. Toronto gets the puck. Here's Matt Hunwick. Lost it in his skates. Zaitsev to Matt Hunwick. Straight up the middle. Hyman tried to tip the puck in. And he got knocked down by Dustin Bufflin. Then there'll be a penalty on the play. Bufflin doesn't like it, but the Maple Leafs are going to go on the power play.
Almost another 3-goal lead for the Toronto Maple Leafs as Hutchinson tries to play this and fans on it. And I think you're right about Matthews trying to bank one in. It almost happened. Hyman was there. And here's the bounce back in the feet of Bufflin. Tries with one hand and just the reaction going down. When I saw it live, it looked like he got his hand up into his face, but when you see it on that replay, I think it was a shoulder on shoulder.
And maybe that's why he was looking inquisitively at the referee, because the referee called roughing.
Live, it really did look like he gave him a forearm shiver, but on that replay there, as Paul Maurice is seething behind the Winnipeg bench.
You think it could have been interference, though?
Yeah, you could call it that, not a rough.
Leafs one of three teams that have yet to score a power play goal. They've had 8 opportunities, haven't been able to get one yet. Matthews stays out on this power play with Kadri and Komarov. William Nylander's there as well. And the one key man is Nikita Zaitsev. Zaitsev is the ice time leader for the Maple Leafs early in the season. And he gets the puck in for Nylander. Kadri in front. Nylander chased to the boards, double team, but he got the puck to Kadri, or got lucky to get it there. Zaitsev turns to the net. There's a tip, one off a skate. Komarov had it go off his skate. Now Nylander. Round for Matthews, and Zaitsev's there as well. The old Komarov. Nylander shoots. Hutchinson got a piece of that. Zaitsev overskated the puck. Mathias trying to get to center. Matthews in a foot race with him. Sean Mathias will be a penalty call.
He's calling.
Can they call both?
He's calling Mathias. And that's what the crowd's reacting to.
Wow.
And Blake Wheeler comes over immediately to have a conversation. Paul Maurice can't believe it. This is one of those battles where you're toe to toe here, and Matthews realized at the end of a shift, he's not going to win this race. And there is definitely the arm going in. And I would say that if anything, you do both. Credit to Matthews, though. Watch, he keeps his feet moving, doesn't stop, and that's what I think does allow that call to be made. So often, Jim, though, when you're the guy reaching in, you're both going to get the penalty. You saw in that play, the left hand was definitely on Matthews' stick there. What an opportunity for the Toronto Maple Leafs here to break this game open.
That's young referee Tom Chmielski who made the call and makes this a 5-on-3 for 1:04. Bozak, Van Riemsdyk, Marner, Morgan Rielly, and Jake Gardner on the 5-on-3. And Bozak's arguing with the linesman Kyle Murchison here about the faceoff. He's getting waved out. Van Riemsdyk comes in against Adam Lowry, who's out with Tyler Myers. Toby Enstrom as the penalty killers. Enstrom with that great reach of his and a long stick gets the puck down the ice. You can tell they're still upset about the penalty call on the 5-on-3. Bozak drops the puck off. Marner to Gardner, and he'll drop it off for Morgan Rielly, and they'll close in. Gardner fires, and Hutchinson makes the save. Gardner again draws in the defender, then passes to Morgan Rielly. Down low, here's Mitch Marner. Back to Rielly. Bozak's parked in front. Marner, Rielly to his forehand, passes off. Van Riemsdyk, Rielly, Gardner, Marner. Fires it across, and Van Riemsdyk settled it down instead of shooting. Rielly fires a shot. Hutchinson the save. The rebound's knocked away before Marner could get a stick on it. Dozen seconds to go. Gardner fires a shot. Hutchinson knocked it down. Sprawling is Tyler Myers, and reaching for the puck is Michael Hutchinson.
Jim, sprawling is an understatement. Myers just took a piece out of Bozak. There's been some great battles going on in front of the net. Look at Bozak with both Enstrom and Myers, and when the play comes back to the net at this point here, it's desperation time. The shots have been all put towards Gardner there, and Gardner couldn't find the seam in between, and there's the cross check going down at the end of what was been a long kill for the penalty killer.
Still 8 seconds before they're through it. They've had 3 shots so far, the Leafs, on a 5-on-3 power play. Shifley to try and win this draw. Leafs get possession. Zaitsev, Austin Matthews passes across, they score! William Nylander! Still 5-on-3, 2 seconds to go in the 5-on-3. Nylander on a great cross-ice pass from Austin Matthews, and it's 3-0 Toronto.
So often we talk about the importance of faceoffs. This one was in play, and Sherratt takes it out to the point, but a heads-up play by Matthews. And an even better shot by Nylander. He doesn't try to rush his shot. He makes sure he gets control, settles it down, puts it on the tee, and goes off the bar and in. Perfectly placed off of an excellent pass through the seam by Matthews.
He gets his first of the season. Matthews gets the first assist at 6:47, and the Leafs continue on the power play, and that's Toronto's first power play goal of the season. Comes on their 10th power play, and here's Nylander again in front. Kadri scores! Eight seconds after the goal by Nylander. Nazem Kadri has his second of the night set up by Nylander, and it's 4-0 Toronto.
And there's times where you're just so frustrated with the calls against for the Winnipeg Jets. You maybe felt you got the raw end of the deal here, but this is just plain and simply being outworked, winning the puck battle, and Nylander again, just a perfectly placed pass. Goes in hard, takes that extra second. You saw him reach around the stick of Ben Sherratt. Didn't force it, made sure the seam was there, and no chance at all for Hutchinson.
8 seconds to part, and you see the frustration in Sean Matthias, who thought he might get a goal. Thought he might draw a penalty shot, ended up with a penalty, and his team shorthanded 5-on-3 for over a minute. And the second period continues to be a problem for the Jets, now outscored 8-0. Bufflin under pressure on a forecheck. Morrissey to Kyle Connor. Couldn't get the puck by Connor Carrick. Joel Armia. Checked by Connor Carrick. Connor Brown battling for the puck. Peter Holland to center for Matt Martin. And he'll chip the puck and turn the defensive pair. And he comes on Bufflin. Got a bit of a hit on him. And Armia's back the other way. Bermistrov breaks up the middle. And Armia fanned on the pass. Marinson is back. Trying to get the puck away from Bermistrov. Armia gave the puck away to Tyler Bozak. And Van Riemsdyk clears the puck for Toronto all the way down the ice. This is an icing call against the Maple Leafs.
Well, what a tough sequence there for the Winnipeg goaltender as well. It didn't have much of a chance on either goal, as you had Nylander with just a perfect shot and then Nylander with another pass. That cross seam is a little delay for Hutchinson to get across, and because it's his blocker side, tough to get up. If that's a glove side, he might have maybe got a piece of it, but you can't shoot it much better than that one.
Toby Enstrom in the middle of the ice. Puck was tipped. Wheeler. Patrick Laine out front. Couldn't handle that pass that went zipping through the top of the blue from Blake Wheeler. Laine. Long shoot in. Wheeler flies in after the puck up against Marinson. Got the puck to Patrick Laine. He's watched by Bozak. Cross ice pass to Tyler Myers. He bobbled it. Makes a move to get away from Van Riemsdyk to the net. Tipped right on by Wheeler. Puck still loose after Anderson made the save. And then pushed underneath him as the Jets come close. Nazem Kadri had one shot on goal, no points entering the night. He's got two goals and an assist tonight for Toronto. For 3-0 to start the season. Two National Hockey League games tomorrow. Tonight's game featuring Toronto and Winnipeg, 4-0 Leafs.
Well, Jim, that entire commercial break, Dustin Bufflin sat right next to Dan O'Rourke and talked to the official about that entire sequence that we just saw. That's made this game a wide open one.
From center, Milan McCulloch trying to dump the puck in. Here's Mathias again streaking towards the net. Just about got the puck from Anderson and went off his stick. Tanev threw the puck at the net and Anderson knocked it away. Tanev trying to throw a hit at Nazem Kadri. Josh Morrissey. Now Hunwick. Kadri saw a big 33 train and Bufflin was coming at him, so he dumped the puck in. Lowry. Kyle Connor. He's got some wheels, but he couldn't go outside in on Nikita Zaitsev. A pretty impressive debut when you think about the World Cup and now his start with the Toronto Maple Leafs. 24-year-old, never drafted, but he played 7 seasons in the KHL.
That was good coordination between his partner Hunwick, too. He didn't overplay and take a penalty, just delivered him once he got beat to Zaitsev, trusting that he was going to be there.
Toby Enstrom pinching, and the Jets will have to do some of that and take some chances here. They need some offense. Tyler Myers. Joel Armia dumped the puck in. Patrick Laine protects the puck and throws it back to the blue line. Postma, Myers waits and takes, and a nice save by Anderson. I think Myers was waiting for a screen, one never came, so he fired a pretty good shot. Now he stands up at the blue line, holds the puck in. There's going to be a hooking penalty to Zach Hyman. Both referees caught that, and the Winnipeg Jets badly needing a goal. Go to the power play for the second time in the game on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey. Green and then drill penalty.
Yeah, a really good shift there as Matthews was in the lane for a second. Good read though by Anderson. Back at the blue line though, he gets inside position on Hyman, keeps the puck and the play alive, and Hyman forced to get the hook in. This is almost a must score right now for this Winnipeg power play.
Halfway through the second period, and it's Shifley, Stafford, Perreault, Wheeler, and Dustin Bufflin out on a power play that is 1-for-14 to start the season. Komarov to take the draw. Puck comes to Dustin Bufflin on the other side. No one-timer. Wheeler back to Bufflin. He shoots a hard one up high off the glass. And then Wheeler played the puck back. Bufflin has to skate to center to get it. Matthew Perreault. Komarov got his stick in. Here comes Wheeler, fires a shot off a stick again. Stafford lost the puck in his feet. All four Leafs were in the corner pressuring the Jets, and they cleared the puck.
Yeah, the Leaf penalty kill right now doesn't allow the Jets to take a breath and take your time, look up and try to make a play. You got to make it under duress.
Wheeler in a hurry after tipping the puck in, but he threw it around on the boards right to Matt Martin. Straight up the middle to Peter Holland. He's got one man to beat. It's Bufflin. And off the heel of his stick, he couldn't get a good shot away. Wheeler under pressure from Carrick, a defenseman up at the blue line. Bufflin up the middle. Perreault to Scheifele. On his own here, double teamed along the boards. Bufflin holds the puck and then he fanned on it, and Holland just about got away. Now in they come Lowry on the other side. Perreault drags the puck in, stopped by Anderson. Bouncing puck, Anderson with another save. Here's Bufflin, one-timer. Anderson made a wonderful save, robbing Kyle Connor. Connor so close to his first NHL goal. And he stays out on this power play that has half a minute to go in it. Ehlers fires a shot, just missed. Lowry after the rebound on the boards. And Connor Carrick was able to hammer it down the ice. With some speed, Nikolai Ehlers to center, cuts into the middle, lost control of the puck. I think the fans, some of them thought there could have been a penalty there too, a little hook in the hands. With some pace, Connor up the middle, dumps the puck in. Vermeestraat throws it back. Hyman came out of the penalty box, couldn't quite control the puck. Tyler Myers is back. The power play for Winnipeg is 0 for 2. They still trail 4 to nothing. Tanev tipped the puck in. Zaitsev is back under pressure. Mathias took the puck away. Leaves it in the corner. Vermeestraat cycles back. Bozak stepped in front of Mathias and charred the puck loose. A couple of nifty little plays there to move the puck to the blue line. Not quite out. Van Riemsdyk. Mitch Marner. Shoot in, he's held up by Myers, so Enstrom gets back to the puck. He's stripped of it by Marner. Mathias against Gardner. Gardner got caught. 2-on-1. Scheifele with Myers. Scheifele to Myers. Scores! Oh boy, the Jets needed that. Tyler Myers. On a 2-on-1 with Mark Scheifele, it's a 4-1 game.
Well, good play here on the boards. Van Riemsdyk falls down. Gardner got caught flat-footed, and what a fake here. Just for a split second, as soon as the defender, Carrick, went down, watch the read. It's just a great read by Scheifele. As soon as the defenseman moves, the lane opens up, and no hesitation on your offside. After seeing Anderson make an unbelievable save earlier on, to keep this a 4-0 game, Myers finally breaks through.
Still a ways to go here. We can get another one at least before the end of this period. We've already had one big comeback against Carolina in their opener. Here's a chance for Perreault in front of the net. Anderson made the save. He doesn't know where the puck is. Played in front, and Ehlers couldn't knock it out of the air after it was fed to him by Drew Stafford. That was almost a repeat of what the Leafs did 8 seconds after a goal.
Well, you can see the jump right after that goal. A big shift here against the Matthews line.
William Nylander, Hyman to the net. The trailer is Austin Matthews. Tried to make a play. Lost control of the puck. But he's got it again. Centering for Nylander. He's double teamed to the blue line. Marinson shot. There's a big save by Hutchinson with Hyman right in front. Zaitsev. To the net, rejected by Bufflin, and he sent the puck out to center. Zaitsev shoots it right back in. Both teams change. Bufflin. Morrissey. Hard around. Zaitsev was there to try and keep the puck in. Ricocheted off a skate. Kadri chopped down by Bufflin. No penalty there. Patrick Laine in over the blue line. Turned back by Marinson. Bufflin again at center on Kadri. Morrissey's back. McCulloch's right on it. Got in and stole the puck. Bufflin stepped in front of Kadri, who's got his stick all tied up with the goaltender Hutchinson. Morgan Riley, a tip in front. Mikolic's knocked down. Shifley back for the puck. Komarov forechecking. To the line, Marinson holds the puck in with a shot just wide of the net. Bufflin's been on for an hour. He needs that more than anybody as he tips the puck to his goaltender for a stop in play. Tyler Myers finally gets Winnipeg on the board on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey.
Beat radio silence from the Jets front office on Jacob Trouba, the 22-year-old defenseman who's sitting home demanding a trade. Larger issue for the Jets here, a team committed to drafting and developing, is keeping its draft picks, especially first-rounders like Trouba. Played 22 minutes a game last season. He's valuable to the Jets, and accommodating a trade at less than the value that they seek would set a dangerous precedent. Jim, I can't imagine Kevin Cheveldayoff moving towards making a less than fair value deal, even if the Jets can't come back in this one and start the season 1-3.
Tough ticking away, too, with the contract. Has to be done by December 1st.
Here's Shifley ahead to Wheeler trying to stride away. The Jets have been coming on here for a little while at 4-0. They finally got it going. Have it 4-1 now. Enstrom with a shot. Anderson save. Rebound. Wheeler's backhander didn't get by Morgan Riley. Tyler Bozak can't make the puck settle down at center. Marinson is back. Shifley goes after the puck as well. Laney. Tried to make a backhand pass. Myers got the puck and threw it wide of the net. Vermistrov, fresh off the bench, into the middle. Paul Postma steps up, couldn't control the puck, and Mitch Marner for Toronto sends it out to center. Ben Riemsdyk tried to dump it in and change. They'll change anyway. Vermistrov made one nice move and then ran into Morgan Riley. Postma dumps the puck in for Winnipeg.
There's the crowd responding to this little jump in energy by the Jets. It's three or four shifts in a row after the goal, a little bit extra effort.
Matt Martin, Vermistrov steers him to the side. Connor Carrick's one-timer. Hutchinson made a good save. Holland trying to center, couldn't do it. You heard the fans react to Connor Carrick's little trip at the side of the net. No penalty call there. Peter Holland into the middle. Martin had the puck tipped away by Joel Armia. Puck still loose and Hutchinson's down. He can't find it. Martin gets it. Back to Carrick. And along the boards, Vermistrov is there to center. Great hand eye by Peter Holland to knock the puck out of the air and come back in. Fires the shot. There's a rebound. Martin just about batted that in with his hand and Hutchinson makes the save and hangs on.
I think Martin, if he had got a piece of that one, probably was going to be called off as he knocked it in. But the plays around the net, a good response here by the Leafs as turnover in the neutral zone. Holland out of midair was able to keep that puck alive and get it hard to the net with traffic. You've seen a lot of that in this period as that one went off the arm. Fluttering puck, and today's NHL player, that's an easy target. They can knock that down like nothing.
Jets win the draw. Matthews' line is on a forecheck here. And Matthews came up with the puck and threw it towards the net. And Hutchinson will force another faceoff.
That's a key turnaround here for Winnipeg. At home ice here, you have a Winter Classic coming up that, you know, will be a unique day. You never know how your team's going to respond to that. So I think Paul Maurice, that urgency came to life after that first goal. They're looking to cut it to two now.
You really want this week to be positive.
Yeah. And this is not one of those games. The big rival, right, like the Maple Leafs, down 4-0. Well, they did it against Carolina. Maybe they can do it again.
Zach Hyman. Puck's poked away from him. Zaitsev holds it in. Matthews drags the puck in. Down, up. Not enough time. Bufflin closed on it. Looked like he made that play in the World Cup and was trying to do it again.
And you see Bufflin, as he missed him the first time, he got up as quick as he could and made sure he closed that gap. He knew the player that he just missed was dangerous.
Nikolai Ehlers with a lovely looking play, and a puck went to the side of the net. Anderson hangs on.
Now, the tough thing about young players is you don't really have a read on them. You're right, Jim. The fact that players around the league were able to watch Matthews in the World Cup, how's he going to play? Well, this deceptiveness, but look at how quickly Bufflin, after he missed him, got right back and didn't allow Matthews to gather himself and give him any time.
Not today, young gun. Lowry and Kadri. Lowry won the draw. Myers has been a real presence in this second period. On with Enstrom, kept the puck in for a moment. Komarov is after Enstrom. Takes the man, separated in from the puck. Back to help out Adam Lowry. Enstrom. Komarov's after him again. Kadri stepped in, couldn't get the puck. Mathias out to center. Tanev breaks up the middle. The pass didn't get through to him. Matt Hunwick. Kadri cuts into the middle, cuts back, turned the puck over. Wheeler. Lenny. Turned and tried to get the forehand shot away. He missed the net. Myers at the blue line trying to hold the puck in, and he did for a moment. Looked like Kadri could get it. Hunwick to Zaitsev. Off the boards, Bozak. All he could do is dump the puck in. Myers watched by Van Riemsdyk. Marner coming off the bench. Overskated the puck against Patrick Laine. Bufflin wants it back. Gets the puck back. Shoots up high. Missed on the short side. Morrissey on the other side. Shot wide in the net. Another chance here for Scheifele. To the blue line. Laine, quick shot. Anderson with a nice save. Frederik Andersen has been getting busier and progressively better as the game goes on.
Yeah, he realized the importance of holding on to that rebound there, because one thing about Bufflin is he can be a presence at both ends of the ice. We saw him defensively on Matthews in there. He just tried to outweight Andersen, and Andersen committed himself early, slid across, but you see the reaction of number 33 there. He knew he missed a good chance.
Anderson's best save came off Kyle Connor, who's on the ice now. Connor says he patterns his game after Matt Duchene. His favorite U of Michigan alumnus is Carl Hagelin. There's Connor Brown with his shot, and he just missed the net. And the common denominator there is speed.
Speed and goals. 35 goals in 38 games for the Wolverines. Unbelievable.
Here he is down the right side. Put the puck in for Joel Armia to go after it. He holds up. Vermistrov gets the puck. Tried a pass that went off a skate. Zaitsev. Here's Bufflin awaiting the arrival of the puck. Joel Armia. Holland battles in there with Connor. Centering pass comes back to Tyler Myers, running out of time in the period. Out of the corner to the net, off the side of the net, and Hunwick plays the puck outside the line, and that'll just about do it. One last chance for Bufflin to take a shot, but the puck got lost in the feet of the linesman, Kyle Murchison. And the second period comes to an end. Coming up in our second intermission, behind the bench with Doug McLean. Through two, it's 4-1 for the Leafs on the road in Winnipeg. Road in Winnipeg, here's Darren Millard.
Thank you, Jim. And because I'm fully supportive of Doug McLean maintaining his employment with us on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey on Sportsnet, I'm not going to ask you to describe what Paul Maurice is going to do during this second intermission, but rather it's been a very effective night for the Toronto Maple Leafs, scoring four goals. What's the secret?
Yeah, I've been in Paul Maurice's situation way too often, and I would not want to repeat what I said or what I used to say. But I'll tell you what, Babcock is going into the dressing room right now, and he's saying, stay aggressive. That's our game. Defense, stay up on the play. Keep pucks alive on the forecheck. Go into the paint even as a defenseman. Let's stay aggressive. We saw the first goal scored that way. Have a look at Riley here coming up ice. Stay strong, comes in, picks the puck up off the forecheck. Now that's a defenseman being aggressive with a great pass to Kadri. On the rush, McCarty gets the puck to the net. You've got crashing that aggressive play by Kadri and Komarov going to the paint. Let's keep the aggressive style. Let's not get caught on pinches like Gardner did on the last goal. If you're going to pinch, you still have to think and safety first, but keep the aggressive play going, boys. This team can come back.
Which they were on the Jets' only goal.
Exactly.
And got caught. So.
And caught, yeah. Like, we want to be aggressive, but we still have to be smart. Safety first. Always keep that in mind.
Elliot, there's people
puzzled
about this Jets performance.
Well, I think one of them is probably Paul Maurice. You didn't want to repeat all the swear words that he might be repeating, but I bet you one question he's going to be asking is, what's the update on Brian Little? They're a very different team without him.
What is that update? Looking at another month?
Well, the Jets are being really quiet about it. They don't think it's super long term, whatever that is, but I don't think that they're, you know, they haven't really given us a fixed date on it.
You brought up Andre Pavlis during the first intermission and some teams that are looking at him. Mike Smith went down, looked really bad last night to Arizona against Ottawa, rolling around. His status and where they go.
No official update from the Coyotes aside from the fact he had an MRI and the team doctors will see when he gets back to Arizona. They've got five games left on the road trip. We're not expecting him to play in any of them. But it sounds like there's hope that this isn't a devastating long-term injury, which is good news for Smith and the club.
Because he has battled that injury situation in the past. Coming up next in the second intermission of Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey, former Winnipeg Jet captain Chris King. He was there when the franchise left. He's back tonight and will be in the city for this weekend's Heritage Classic. Not the night that the Winnipeg Jets wanted tonight as they trail 4-1 against the Toronto Maple Leafs, but this is part of a big weekend in Winnipeg. The Heritage Classic coming up on Sunday. Before that, there's an alumni game on Saturday afternoon, and taking part in that, part of the Hockey Operations Department with the National Hockey League, and former Winnipeg Jet captain is Chris King, who joins us now from Winnipeg. You were there when the franchise left in the mid-90s, Chris. Did you ever see this type of celebration coming back to Manitoba Capital?
Well, no, Darren, I didn't. It was a very bittersweet departure, as you were part of, and it was tough on the players. It was tough on the players' families and, of course, the fans. So I think the excitement that's being generated not only for the real game, as I call it, between the Jets and the Oilers, but there's been a lot of talk and a lot of excitement about the alumni for both teams coming here and spending the first two periods with some of my old teammates and some of the other guys that that I played against that are now on the Jets alumni team. Everybody's pretty excited about it.
You know, I keep hearing that people call it a fishbowl environment in the National Hockey League because it is a small center. How did you find it?
You know what, Darren, as a visitor to Winnipeg, you didn't get a chance to know what the city was all about. You got off at the airport, you drove on a bus with frosted windows down to the Fairmont and then back to the arena, and that's really all you saw. And then when I got traded from the Rangers to Winnipeg, I didn't know what to expect. But coming from small town Northern Ontario to arguably the smallest NHL town, it was a perfect fit for me, a perfect fit for my family. We had a lot of great friends away from the game, a lot of great friends on our team that we still call friends. It was a tight-knit group, and I think a lot of it had to do with the way we were treated as players by the fans base here. I played 15 years, and the 4 years that I played here in Winnipeg were probably the most enjoyable 4 years of my career.
Just want to play you one piece of tape from when the team left, and you were part of this. And true or false that this story really came from the night before when the team was together. Here is Eddie Olczyk.
Wherever this team ends up, and when this team wins the Stanley Cup, it's coming back to Winnipeg!
How many times you heard that?
I've heard it too much. And I'm sure I'm going to hear it again this weekend. That's the only reason that we brought Eddie back. It's certainly not for his playing skills, but he made a promise, so we're going to give him the opportunity to fulfill that promise.
How's the facility before we go? Just 10 seconds on that.
It's great. You know, I was there just before the game. The guys put in the logos last night. The ice is great, and it's going to be fantastic for the weekend. The weather's changing. It's a little nice and cold, as I remember, and everybody's going to have a good time. Now, before I go, lots of people have been asking about you and wonder why you're not here, and I told them that you're just too busy. Is that fair?
Thanks, pal. Maple Leafs lead it 4-1.
You got it.
Nylander getting into the scoring act as he takes the feed from the first overall pick, and it's 4-1. Toronto leads here in the second intermission of Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey. Sportsnet Central update, Ken Reid, Ivanka Osmak stepping in. You guys hear how big I am in Winnipeg and Manitoba? Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're taking over.
Well, Canadians are a lot like me, probably still drying my tears after this afternoon's loss for the Jays. Yeah. Their season is done. We'll have plenty more on the ALCS loss coming up on Sportsnet Central after tonight's game. But there is one other game on the ice going on right now.
Just one other game. Red Wings and the New York Rangers. Quick highlight pack for you. First period, Ryan McDonough from the point. It is tipped in by Mika Zibanejad. This is his second goal of the season. That puts the Rangers up 1-0 early on. We go to the second. Red Wings on the power play. Franz Nielsen the point shot. Thomas Vanek gets a piece of this puck for his third of the season. Ties this game up at ones. That's where we sit after 40 minutes.
Nail Yakupov is back in Edmonton. Yes, he's playing against the Oilers tomorrow night, returning for the first time since that trade to St. Louis in the preseason. Former first overall pick, however, says it's just another game.
I had already first start. We played already four games, so it's the same thing. I mean, we still play hockey, you know. And we just I just moved to a different country, different city, and played with different guys. But now these guys are my family now, so I'm really into it. So you know, it's, you know, I feel good now. You know, a couple of days was kind of hard, but now I feel pretty good.
Sportsnet Central coming up after the game. And Ivanka, as we did every Wednesday night last year, we have to do it again. This year, we have to ask Darren something.
Millard, will you please say hi to the legend, Doug McLean, for us? And Elliot as well.
But mostly Doug.
In that order. Doug first, but I'll do it separately. Doug likes his cell phone. Jets trail 4-0 in that second. Tyler Myers got them on the board. See if they have a second big comeback early in this NHL season.
PS Center. In the last World Hockey Association game ever played, the Jets beat the Oilers 7-3. To win the Avco Cup. And with the Heritage Classic coming up at Investors Group Field this weekend, celebration of the game is on in Winnipeg. The WHA Jets 3 Avco banners hang now at MTS Center, and Hedberg, Hull, and Nielsen honored tonight as they went into the Jets Hockey Hall of Fame. Jets also invited 75 players from both the WHA and Jets 1.0 eras to take part in the Heritage Classic, and over 50 have accepted the invitation, Jim.
So it'll be a fun and festive week in Winnipeg. A lot of the players, some in town already, like Chris King, many coming in tomorrow. They like the Jets to mount a big comeback like they did in their opener against Carolina when they were behind 4-1 in the third period, came back and won in overtime on a Scheifele goal.
Well, that's one thing Paul Maurice was saying about this year's group, that he felt that they had at least that firepower. They had that offensive flair, and we saw when they got that goal in the second period for a good 4 or 5 minutes, the push came on. That's the mentality you have to have here in the third.
Bozak, Van Riemsdyk, Mitch Marner on the ice for Toronto in the attacking zone. Ben Chiarot up the boards. And the puck's dumped out to center. Wheeler with Ehlers and Perreault. So some juggling of lines here by Paul Maurice. Long stretch pass to Nikolai Ehlers. Turns, he's waiting for some help. In comes Perreault. Ehlers goes to the front of the net. Wheeler back to the blue line. Chiarot with a shot that's knocked down. Blake Wheeler gathers it in with room, fires a shot. There's a rebound off Anderson, and Ehlers couldn't quite handle it side of the net. Perreault in front of the goal. And this new look line to start the third period had a pretty nice shift.
Well, you try to make a little change to get a bit of a different rhythm in a line, and it works effectively. And for Anderson, he's just trying to fight through the Perreault screen in front. He does a nice job, keeps the rebounds to the outside, keeps everything from a safe distance. And really important third here for Toronto with two more games in the next 3 days coming up on the road.
Scheifele and Laine stay together. They have Drew Stafford with them. There's a pass to the front of the net. Laine shoots, he scores! Dustin Byfuglien to Patrick Laine, and it's a 4-2 Leaf lead.
Well, the importance again of a faceoff. This is a shot from the point that almost looked like it was intended for Laine to tip it. Instead of tipping it, he gets it cupped right on the curve of his stick, stops it, and what a turnaround. The book on Patrick Laine is that incredible quick release, able to fire the puck with very little room, and that one is more about the positioning right by the ear of Anderson and off the crossbar and in.
I'll cue the comeback. Laine's got his second. Byfuglien and Scheifele get assists. 1 minute into the third period. It's a two-goal game. Laine with his fourth shot of the game. His first point. Matthews has three shots, has an assist in the 1-2 battle tonight. But more importantly, the Jets have closed to within a couple, and here they come again. Stafford takes a shot, and there's a save by Freddie Anderson, and he stops playing.
Well, that's one way to get this crowd to the feet is Bufflin. You could see his head was up, so this is a shot pass the entire way. But the ability to just corral that puck and get it off with both sticks of Komarov and Marincin there, and no chance at all for Anderson. That's a great goal under pressure from two players.
Vermistrov, Connor, Brandon Tanev together now for Winnipeg. Long pass at center goes the distance, and there's an icing call against Toronto.
Introducing Boston Pizza's Halftime Lunch. Get in, get out in no time. New Halftime Lunch at Boston Pizza.
So one coach wants his team to stay up on their toes, Paul Maurice, and I think Mike Babcock would want a little more of that too. Get his team skating again, have a good pushback shift. Peter Holland's line on the ice after the icing call. They were fresh when they iced it. Zaitsev up the boards. Postma holds the puck in out of the reach of Brandon Tanev. Connor Brown chopped the puck to center. Matt Martin with Postma back. Backhand shot. Hutchinson made the save. He's got to be perfect now. Here's Kyle Connor. Picks up speed to center. Chased by Holland. Moves in with a shot. Anderson made the save and smothered the puck.
Jim, a game can get away from you in quick fashion, and the Jets are a good example of that in this one. It looked like they had their chance in the second period to turn things around, and instead of maybe getting something going, they took a couple of penalties, and credit to Toronto. They made them pay. 8 seconds apart did the Toronto Maple Leafs turn this game, and that's the difference right now, those two goals.
Nylander 5-on-3, Kadri 5-on-4. Enstrom with a shot that was knocked down before it got to the net. Another shot. Anderson with a save, and he clasps the puck to his chest. Pretty good action in front of the net.
That's a key time for Anderson, too. He's trying to get the confidence of your group that I can shut the door. Not much he could do on that line A shot, but the one constant theme here is traffic to the front. There was a rebound there. There might have been a bad chance. Instead, he's able to hold on.
Jets get the draw. Myers took a shot. Hyman got right out there and blocked that shot. Wheeler into the corner, now to the front of the net. Myers, shifty move, slap pass. Wheeler's stick was tied up. Enstrom holds the puck in to the captain of the Jets, Blake Wheeler. Connor Carrick up the boards. Myers pinched, held the puck into the front of the net. Wheeler couldn't shoot. Perreault did, and that was blocked before it got to Anderson. Enstrom holds the puck in. Wheeler stops up on the other side. Myers fires. Anderson the save. The rebound. Wheeler backhander. Great save by Anderson. Here comes Enstrom. Over to Tyler Myers, and he passes the puck into the corner. Big battle in front. Perreault working against Jake Gardner. In comes Nikolai Ehlers. An inspired Jets group led by their captain, Blake Wheeler. They'll hold the puck in again. Myers. Flipped back to the blue line, but the defense was on a change, and Ehlers made the pass. There was nobody there. Drew Stafford right off the bench into the play, and it's just offside. Ehlers was sliding, trying to get out, and couldn't.
Well, we mentioned the call that went against Winnipeg in the second, and the Maple Leafs made them pay here. No call made there. You thought, I think, in the building, even Perreault thought he might get it. That's why he was arguing it. Instead, no call, good chances, and Anderson having to fight through some traffic. Not once, but twice. Losing his stick, but still finding that puck in a crowd to make the second save.
Craig, this looks more like the start of the game when the Jets outshot the Leafs 7-0. It's 7-1 here in the third period. The difference is they've scored. Marner back to the blue line. Here's Marincin with a shot. There's a rebound. Marner is stopped by Hutchinson. That would have been huge. Big save by Michael Hutchinson. Stafford lost control of the puck on this fresh ice.
Hutchinson is at that spot, Jim, where you can't afford a mistake. And there was just a good second effort to get across and somehow make that one.
Here come the Jets again. Great move by Stafford and a good stick by Morgan Riley and then by Leo Komarov. And the puck is shot out to center. Enstrom. Adam Lowry tried to return the pass, and it deflected over the glass off of Milan McCullough.
Well, Mitch Marner looking for his second career goal. Thought he had it. In on the forecheck, line A, got into the pile, couldn't find it. And then underneath him was Marner getting that rebound, but really good tracking there by Hutchinson. He knew that he couldn't control the rebound, but his anticipation and aggressiveness across just took away anything down low for Marner to get the puck through to.
Jets send out Vermistrov, Kyle Connor, Brandon Tanev. They're forced back into their own zone by the fourth line of the Maple Leafs, centered by Peter Holland. And Holland gets that puck off the boards, but it was a hand pass, so says the linesman, Kyle Murchison.
Well, these are the types of games early on in the season, too. It's been a slow week for the Toronto Maple Leafs. Lots of practice, only two games in that first week. But you know that as a player, that things speed up. When you have a downtime, you know you've got a lot. So it's really important to get this first win, having to go into Minnesota tomorrow and then Chicago on Saturday.
Hunwick drives the puck in. Brown's in after it. Ben Sherratt had a look around. Shovels the puck to his partner. Postma up the boards. Tanev into the middle. Connor with some speed in on Zaitsev. No gap. And the young Russian defenseman made a nice play but can't get the puck out. Here's Tanev. Sherratt, the defenseman, jumped to the front of the net. And so did Postma get in deep, too deep. And Hutchinson's got to come up to help out, but the Leafs needed a change anyway. Hyman forechecking. Joel Armia stripped to the puck by Nylander. Head up, takes the shot, just missed the net. Gardner from the other side threw the puck at the net, and Hutchinson calmly made that save in front of Zach Hyman.
Well, you're quickly seeing William Nylander show that he's a dangerous player, and those little turnovers that plagued the Winnipeg Jets in the first period here come back as Nylander, with a good stick, is thinking pass. You can see him peek over his shoulder looking to see where Austin Matthews was. No chance to get that, so he tries to go high and beat the goaltender on the glove side.
Mike Babcock left that line on the ice, and Paul Maurice counters with this line he put together to start the third period. Ehlers trying to get a hold of the puck. It's loose at the side of the net. Matthews is out front. Nylander couldn't feed the puck there. Gardner, Carrick to the front of the net. Puck didn't get to the goaltender, and Ehlers takes off the other way in a hurry. Wheeler drives up the middle of the net. Perreault comes up late. Gardner stayed right with Wheeler, ended up getting the puck back. Glassing out. Matthews will go after it late in his shift. D to D, Enstrom to Myers and back. Leafs have changed, man. Riemsdyk is the forechecker. Out with Bozak. Mitch Marner. Tip in by Ehlers, ends his shift. Scheifele let the puck go for Stafford. An interception by Riley. He couldn't clear the puck. It bounced to Scheifele to the blue line. Morrissey with his shot. It came to Scheifele. He shoots. He scores! A block that dropped at the skates of Mark Scheifele, and a terrific shot makes this a one-goal game.
Well, and Scheifele keeps the play alive here as Morgan Riley has a chance, can't clear it, can't find it, and just bad luck there for Marner. He does everything in his power to block that shot, but after getting hit with it, can't get up. Curling from the side, watch the quick release. We saw Line A earlier with the release down low. This one just perfectly placed. Another rolling puck, Jim, that actually aided Scheifele in getting it up and over the blocker side of the Toronto netminder.
A 4-3 game, three straight goals by the Winnipeg Jets after falling behind 4-0. And we're in for a big finish here in Winnipeg. Mark Scheifele's already got three. Josh Morrissey with an assist on the play. See what happens the next shift. Leafs trying to bounce back. Here's a chance for Kadri. Snapped the shot that was blocked by Morrissey. He's hurt. That came close to the net after the block. Hunwick. Zaitsev. His shot is knocked down and hit Leo Komarov. Lowry trying to get the puck out of his own zone. Gets a little help. Matthias. Anderson comes out to meet the puck and play it to Hunwick. Flying off the bench after a short rest. Here comes Scheifele once again. playing the big boys as much as he can to try and get back in the game, and he's certainly done that. Paul Maurice and his team within a goal. There's an icing call against Toronto.
Well, when your team comes on offensively, you better make sure you shut the door. And here is the Leafs coming in. Morrissey gets it right between the legs there. And then afterwards, off the blocker and just about down and in. So a desperation block there by the Jets defenseman. And then almost a strange play that got by the goaltender.
So right back to Scheifele. And Patrick Laine, whose shot didn't miss by much. Man, he can get that away hard and quick. Stafford is with the mid center. In over the blue line here. Connor Brown into the middle. Martin's shot was blocked. Scheifele up the boards and out. Connor Brown is back for the puck for Toronto. Shots are even at 29-29. Pretty even game right now. A steal and Scheifele holds the puck in. Laine is right there. Bounced by Morgan Riley. Martin up the boards. Peter Holland to an open wing. Enstrom is back. Brown is right on it. Here's Laine with Scheifele. Slap shot wide of the net. Anderson tried to hit that. Riley. Hard up the boards. Tipped by Hyman in deep, and now he'll forecheck. Bufflin is back. Just about gave the puck away to Nylander. Perreault. Morrissey on pass at center. Hunwick right there as Wheeler took the puck. Ehlers centering pass. Perreault just missed it. Back the other way come the Maple Leafs. Zach Hyman dumped the puck in, and Zaitsev with him, but he couldn't quite get ahead of him to take a pass. And back come the Jets. Nikolai Ehlers with Perreault right behind him. Dumps the puck in on Wheeler's side. Hunwick. Marner up the boards to Van Riemsdyk. Into the middle. Here's Austin Matthews. One man back. It's Sherratt who has a good stick. Matthews got the puck deep. He needs to change. The Bozak line is coming on for Toronto. Myers is back in his own zone. Ehlers in the midst of a change. And Tanev sprinting through the middle of the ice. Perreault's late in his shift, so he dumps the puck in. Tanev in on the fly. Big collision there. Connor Carrick and Brandon Tanev. And back comes Jake Gardner with the puck. His pass missed Marner. Enstrom flushed out quickly by Van Riemsdyk. Kyle Connor quickly up the boards. Here's Bermistroff. Tanev with him as he zigzags in over the line. Tried to take a shot. Carrick wouldn't let it. Van Riemsdyk. An outlet pass missed Marner. Both teams need changes here. Almost halfway through a frantic third period. The Leafs had a 4-0 lead. Jets are now within one. Matthias, first man in on the puck. Hit by Komarov. Leafs had it, lost it. Anderson to Zaitsev. His outlet. Turned over. Sean Matthias to the net. Stopped by Anderson. Zaitsev up the boards again. Morrissey pinches and holds the puck in. Komarov trying to send McCulloch away. And the puck deflected down the ice. Bufflin is back. Joel Armia. With some speed. Matthias wanted the puck. Armia didn't give it to him. Gets the puck inside the line anyway. Scheifele's off the bench. Controls a bouncing puck to the blue line. Myers dumps the puck in deep out of the air. Holland knocked the puck, but he didn't get it out. Martin pushes the puck up the boards at center. Here's Peter Holland. He's got Brown with him. Delays, shoots. Hutchinson makes the save. Nobody wants to take a penalty here. Don't let them take one out of this group. Martin and Scheifele, Stafford involved. Patrick Laine's second of the season. Mark Scheifele's third. The Jets are within one on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey. 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific on Sportsnet. We're in the eighth inning of this one.
It looked like it was going to be over, though, didn't it? Earlier on. The Jets have flown back into this.
Got into the Leafs bullpen. And it's a 4-3 game. Hyman centering pass. Big save there on Austin Matthews by Michael Hutchinson. And he's made a few with the game getting closer. Hyman trying to cycle back against Myers. Matthews, Nylander in traffic. Hyman can't get loose. He's tied up by Toby Enstrom. There's a pocket pick by Matthews. Nylander in front couldn't get the puck. The Jets get to center. Scheifele with some speed. Nylander back checking. There's a chance for Stafford and a quick shot in front by Patrick Laine again off a stick. Scheifele to the blue line. Tyler Myers has been a tower since this game got to 4-0. Literally and figuratively. Scheifele holding the puck in. Morgan Riley jumps in front of Stafford. Up the boards. Marinson got the puck to center. Myers quickly back in on a leaf change. Laine couldn't handle the puck. Fires a shot. He could handle it then. Bufflin had the puck bounce over his stick and McCulloch's right after him. Morrissey up the boards. Kadri takes over for Toronto. Zaitsev to Hunwick. And long pass to McCulloch, who tips it in. Bufflin is back. Nikolai Ehlers along the boards. Wheeler flying through center. They couldn't hit him with a pass, nor could they get the pass to Bufflin. Bufflin threw the puck in front of the net. An arm went up for icing, waved out by the linesman who was closest to the play.
And Bufflin again. He got in there first, Jim. He's been all over the ice as well.
Here's Wheeler. Pushed down by Kadri, gets up and protects the puck into the middle. Quick shot by Ehlers, went off a skate. Ehlers again to the net, and Anderson makes the save and stops play. It's fast and furious in Winnipeg in a one-goal game on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey.
Who's won this trade? It's what we always hear whenever a trade is made, and time tells us the Jets have won the February of 2015 blockbuster trade with Buffalo by a knockout. Stafford, Myers, Armia, all important players for the Jets, and Evander Kane, centerpiece of the trade for the Sabres in a season and a half, has played 66 games. Currently out with cracked ribs. So how these players have fitted in Winnipeg, Jim, makes it a unanimous decision for the Jets.
Here they come again. Bufflin's been a big part of it. So has Tyler Myers. And two other draft picks in that trade, too, that are playing for the Manitoba Moose. Here's Bufflin with a shot. Anderson with a save as the Jets come close again. Tyler Myers, the aforementioned defenseman, has 9 shot attempts tonight. Bufflin's got a few as well. He's been all over the ice.
Yeah, Bufflin just senses when he can jump up in the play, likes to do it, and this is one that he's looking desperately for a rebound. You got two Jets going to the net. Bozak does a nice job of boxing out Perreault, and Ehlers couldn't find the handle, but Anderson able to hold on.
Here's the line that got Winnipeg started in the period. Perreault, Ehlers, and Wheeler, and they get the draw again. Ehlers' shot just missed. Wheeler's shot blocked before it got to the net. Ehlers at the blue line. Shifty move to get open. In he comes and shoots wide of the net. And off the boards, the Leafs scramble to get the puck. Connor Brown out to center, trying to make this a 3-on-2. Passes out of the reach of Holland, but he goes in after it. Morrissey up the board. Zaitsev pinches, and he held the puck in. Morrissey to Bufflin. Leafs want to change and decided they better not do it here with Morrissey rushing to center. He hit the linesman. Puck came back towards him. Zaitsev. Nazem Kadri gathers in the bouncing puck, but he's not moving very fast at center, and he got his pocket pick. Scheifele took a shot that Marinson blocked and sent out of play. A big weekend here in Winnipeg and another big weekend of Hockey Night in Canada. Kadri and the Leafs are in tough against Jonathan Toews and the Hawks as they head for Chicago on this road trip. Vancouver Canucks battle the Los Angeles Kings in Los Angeles, and the Kings struggle out of the gate without Jonathan Quick. That's Saturday, Hockey Night in Canada on CBC. Lowry and Kadri face off. Leafs get the draw. Marinson up the boards. Tipped out of the air. McCulloch went after the puck that he tipped. Toby Enstrom beat him to it. Komarov forechecking. Myers. Now Enstrom. Slowly to center. Now Myers strides through the middle of the ice. Backhands the puck into Lowry. He'll battle Connor Carrick. Up the boards, Komarov against a pinching Myers goes back the other way. Carrick to Gardner. Armia forechecking. To the blue line, puck doesn't get out. Matthews lost his stick. Gardner to center. Bufflin rink wide, Tyler Myers into the middle. Bouncing puck knocked away from Armia by Gardner. And the Leafs are able to clear the puck. Matthews and Hyman will forecheck. Line A is back. Number two against number one, and number one just about stole the puck. Marinson holds it in with a backhand shot. And Hutchinson makes the save. Down to 5.5 minutes to go in the third in a one-goal game on Scotiabank Wednesday Night Hockey. Come back from opening night.
Yeah, they were down 4-1. Patrick Laine makes it 4-3. Then the nifty pass with his first assist to get Perreault to tie it up. And then in overtime, Wheeler to Scheifele and the comeback complete. Will history repeat itself here? Third period's been their best offensively, and it continues to be so in this game.
Leafs win the draw. Marinson's shot. Hutchinson got a piece of that. Stafford with Laine over on the other side. And he gathers in the puck. Scheifele's in the middle. Bouncing puck. Stolen by Mitch Marner, and he dumps it in. Van Riemsdyk forecheck on Morrissey. Marner is there to the blue line. Marinson fires his shot. Laine got a little piece of that and went way wide. Stafford will start out for Winnipeg. Rink wide. Scheifele can't gather the puck in. Marinson. Backhander to center. Marner pounces on it. Van Riemsdyk falls in behind. Here's Marner. Head up. Feeds the puck in front. Bozak couldn't get a shot away. And he's double-teamed in the corner, and Morrissey gets the puck to center.
I don't think Bozak thought that Marner would even attempt that pass across, and it almost floated down perfectly for a quick shot.
You can see him looking, and then he decided to try it and got it through. Here's Wheeler. He's been terrific in this period. Up the middle. Matthew Perreault from Wheeler. Stops. Fell down. Couldn't get the shot. Wheeler just about got it. Zaitsev cleared it just in time. Wheeler's held the puck in. Perreault twists to get away from Komarov. There's a centering pass. Went off the side of the net. Wheeler feeds it in front off of goaltender Anderson. And the Leafs get the puck. Kadri flips the puck in on Hutchinson. Toronto changing on the fly. Still just over 4 minutes to go. Here comes Tyler Myers to the blue line. He shoots the puck in. Gardner had a look around before he turned and got back. He sees Winnipeg on a change. Up the boards, Connor Brown. In over the blue line, Martin is with him. He'll stop up, but he fell down. Enstrom gets the puck ahead. Kyle Connor couldn't get it out. Turned back for Bistroff, tripped up. Myers again out of the reach of Tanev. And this is close. Fans thought Tanev was ahead. This is an icing call against Winnipeg.
One thing we've mentioned many times is the creativity of young players, and sometimes, Jim, even that naivety, that is, they'll try anything. And I said the bouncing puck there for Bozak. So often your coach will say, be safe, keep it to the outside. There was a high-skilled play that almost ended up paying off.
Matthews, Nylander, and Hyman again. Matthews got the draw. Hunwick passes back to William Nylander. His shot is blocked by Tyler Myers. Bistroff's line caught on an icing call on the ice against Matthews' group. Hyman and Enstrom main participants in this battle. Leafs get the puck. Matthews wraparound attempt. Rattles around in front of the net. Myers calmly clears it away before Matthews could get a second chance. Out to center. Tanev. Kyle Connor and the puck bounced on him. He couldn't get away. Hyman's back the other way. Matthews goes to the net. Hyman's shot. Kicked out. Hyman again. Stopped by Michael Hutchinson. And Dustin Byfuglien settles the puck down and flips it out to center. Under three to go in the third. Marinson to center. Morrissey stands up there. Kadri got a hold of the puck and dumped it in. Byfuglien's back. One forechecker, the rest of the Leafs in the neutral zone. They clog it up and get the puck. McCulloch to Kadri, just ahead of him. Pokes the puck in for Komarov. He wins the battle, just about got it out front. McCulloch was there. Hutchinson cut it off.
Jim, the last three or four shifts now, the Leafs, instead of just defending and being on an onslaught, they've had a good offensive push. They've turned some pucks over. They've got it down deep to the front of the net, and Hyman here gets not one, but that second chance had an opportunity to get past Hutchinson as well. That's the best way to defend, is
keep it in the offensive zone.
They haven't done that all the way through this period. They've been outshot 15-4 and outscored 2-0.
You think, though, for Mike Babcock, you've got six rookies in your lineup. There's nowhere to hide. You
got to play them.
You got to play them. You got to put them through those scenarios of trying to defend and get a one-goal game to the finish line.
And he hasn't shortened up at all. He's played four lines right through this third period.
But you see a ton of that, don't you? After every player comes back, young and old, there's a lot of discussion with this group, as there are with most.
Bozak to take the draw, wins it back. Huntlick with a shot, went off a skate. Mathias chops at the puck to try and get it out. Zach Hyman out here in Marner's spot with Bozak and Van Riemsdyk. Maybe a little better bet defensively.
Hyman's a guy that Mike Babcock has really grown to trust.
Lowry at center was checked and the puck flew up in the air off his stick. Enstrom moves it in. Zaitsev moves it out for Toronto. Bozak. Van Riemsdyk has a step on Myers, but not a stick. Great reach by Myers. Knocked that up over the net. Myers against Komarov is forced to turn back. A one-goal game and 1:45 on the clock. Tyler Myers steps out from behind the net. Long pass at center. Scheifele and Wheeler back together again as the Leafs turn this back. Matthew Perreault is with them. Nikolai Ehlers. Scheifele's long pass. He gets it through. Wheeler dumps it in. Goaltender's headed for the bench with the extra attacker coming on. Ehlers fires a shot. He missed the net. Wheeler on the other side protects the puck from Milan McCullough. In to help is Matthew Perreault, and the Leafs will leave it here all day. Back to the blue line. Line A. Ehlers. Bufflin off the bar and into the netting.
And the Jets are going to get a power play here as Riley just tackled Scheifele. A great battle going on the boards, trying to get desperately to the front of the net, and he's forced to haul him down. And there's an argument. That's a key defender for Mike Babcock, too. Morgan Riley, here's the anxious battle on the boards. Three Toronto Maple Leafs, two Jets. The Jets end up coming out with it. And there's the cross-check down as box out. As Scheifele trying to go to the net, number 44 just boxed him right out.
Off the corner where the bar meets the post and out. They had five forwards and a D-man Bufflin on the ice, and there's the penalty. And if ever the Jets needed their power play to help them, it's right now.
Now, lots of discussion about that one as Morgan Riley didn't like the call. As usually late in a game like that, Jim, anything goes. You try to hack and whack and cross-check as much as you can, but he got caught on that one.
So after the timeout taken by the Maple Leafs.
Face-off, so important. We've seen the one power play goal scored off of face-offs for Nylander. Beautiful executed. And then the Jets got themselves back into it with a face-off win and a key goal. So everybody bearing down here on this one. Dale Hawerchuk was a pretty good face-off man himself in his day.
Love to be in this situation.
I think for Jets fans, they go back to 1990, double overtime. Dave Ellett off a face-off that won it for the Jets and put them up 3-1.
Perreault, Wheeler, Scheifele, Hyman trying to win the draw. It doesn't get out. Ehlers, Line A shoots, he scores! Patrick Laine, second of the night, tie game.
And what a bad break for Carrick. As this play, puck is in play, Carrick tries to just bang it out. Now everybody's panicking going back. Look at how far out Anderson was. He expected, like everybody in the building, that the shot was coming from Ehlers. We've said it before, the big bomb for Patrick Laine is his best asset, and what a bad feeling for Morgan Riley as he looks down. You couldn't have executed a play better, though. Ehlers sold shot, pass across, and a perfect one-timer by the young number two overall pick.
after a pretty well-executed draw for the Leafs, you're right. And Carrick just couldn't get it out, but what a heads-up play by Ehlers. So, tie game. Another big comeback for the Winnipeg Jets. Van Riemsdyk is in deep. Bozak is there with it. Enstrom. Van Riemsdyk checks it. Bozak trying to get the puck. Collapsing back, Sean Matthias gets the puck and he clears it up. Morgan Riley back and an icing call against Winnipeg with 16 seconds to go in the third period.
Well, you hope if you're a Jets fan that that icing there, Sean Matthias now dead tired, and already Paul Maurice has taken his timeout, so there's no chance for a rest here. Mike Babcock just trusting his team offensively to try to jump on
it. I think Maurice still has his. I think the last one
one was Babcock taking the chance. What an opportunity that was then.
And so he does take his 30-second timeout here to talk about a big face-off again. Babcock had Zach Hyman take that last draw in his own zone, and he won it back for Carrick, who tried to clear it, couldn't get it out. So the goal's line A from Ehlers in 1905.
Boy, very similar, though. You saw it was Sherratt on the penalty kill that tried the same thing as Carrick, tried to shoot it out, and it never got there, and it ended up in the back of the net. And there, Carrick just tried to put everything he could on that to get it out, and instead, Ehlers made the amazing play.
Austin Matthews has an assist tonight on a goal that made it 3-0. Patrick Laine has 4 shots, 10 shot attempts in 18 minutes of ice time, and 2 goals. Nylander on his strong side to take the draw. Matthews and Hyman with it. Adam Lowry to try and win it for the Jets, and he does, into the feet of the linesman. Tyler Myers on the boards. Rookie Tanev trying to get it out, can't do it. Matthews kept it in. Here's Nylander, back to the blue line. Riley running out of time. Zaitsev shoots into traffic. Matthews with a chance, and he knew he was running out of time. Missed the shot, and this game goes to overtime.
Missed the shot, but Jim, that had a chance. If he's maybe in a little bit more balance, he didn't have to rotate his body so much, he might have been able to get a quick shot away. D to D creates some havoc in front. The rebound's there for a split second, and oh, Austin Matthews had to reach back to get that one.
A few different characters involved, but another big comeback for Winnipeg in the third.
Well, there's the faceoff earlier we were talking about. Patrick Laine, just a minute into the third period, gave the Jets a little bit of hope. And then Mark Scheifele showing his ability, jumping off the half wall. Another block shot by Marner and a quick wrister that goes up and over the blocker. And here's that play that brings us to overtime, selling the shot hard. And Charlie Huddy was saying, Patrick Laine, that shot of his can go in so many different places and get it off, as we've seen. Quick from in tight, and that one getting down the ladder and almost on one knee, a la Brett Hull, to put it in the back of the net.
Well, think of the great possibilities for this 3-on-3 overtime.
Are you thinking North America against Sweden, the way that that game went going? Back and forth.
Yeah, chance, it could be like chance. That.
That was one of the real highlights of the World Cup. Watching and doing that one.
Morgan Riley was very much involved in that. 10 rookies in the game here tonight, and all of them with a great high skill level. You could bet Dustin Byfuglien will have some involvement here.
You go from 44 on the Leafs to how about 33 on the Jets? He seems to be a little everywhere. One guy, though, the World Cup to me has done a lot for is that man Scheifele, a young up and coming superstar, in my opinion. Thought he really handled himself amongst the game's best at the World Cup. Didn't look at all out of place, and he's followed it up here with a great start to the season.
And on this team, amongst all these young players, he takes on such a big role without Brian Little, and he's only 23 years old. Seasoned vet. Kadri Komarov and Morgan Riley. Wheeler, Scheifele, and Dustin Byfuglien. And overtime's underway at 4-4. Leo Komarov in, fakes the shot. Puck stolen away. Riley followed and took a shot wide. Kadri against Byfuglien to Morgan Riley in the neutral zone. Byfuglien stays on it. Kadri now watched by Scheifele as he backs up. Scheifele knocked the puck out of the air. Not a high stick either. Now he's got control. In comes Wheeler. They got crossed up and Scheifele got checked. Scheifele wins that little battle. Here's Bufflin. Komarov trying to battle with him. And he knocked the puck loose. Morgan Riley's got it. Flushed out quickly by Wheeler. Headed center. Here's Leo Komarov with Kadri. Fires a shot. There's a rebound. And it's gobbled up by Wheeler. And he heads the other way on a change. Zaitsev gets back off the bench. Wheeler to the middle. Can't get the shot. Tyler Myers follows and he gets the puck. Nikita Zaitsev. Tyler Bozak. There's only two of them right now because Komarov's changing. Zaitsev waiting. Got away from Matthew Perreault, and now he starts out and turns back. And he's got Van Riemsdyk with him. JVR, watched by Patrick Laine, picks up some speed to the net. Stopped by Hutchinson. What a huge save by Michael Hutchinson on James Van Riemsdyk. Jake Gardner battled to get back against a tired Matthew Perreault, and now he turns and looks up ice. He's got a little room. Austin Matthews has come onto the ice and takes the pass. Gardner's with him, heads for the net. Coming up late, Nylander. Matthews shoots, that's blocked. Another shot. Hutchinson makes the save.
When you've got four forwards and only two defense out there, each team thinking offensively, and a heads-up play by Van Riemsdyk sees that he's got the rookie Laine, who's not well-versed in playing defensively in the National Hockey League, and now another chance. This time, though, on the doorstep, Myers at least gets a piece of that for Matthews and doesn't allow him a free lane to the net.
Scheifele and Wheeler are back. Nylander and Matthews stay. Morgan Riley is in behind them. Toby Enstrom, the third Winnipeg Jet. Nylander got the puck, but he got it by Riley, who's got lots of speed to get back, even against Wheeler. Matthews. Scheifele's right on him. Morgan Riley up the boards. Nylander will try and track this down. He got a favorable bounce. Matthews gets in, gets the puck. Nylander tried to pass to Matthews and a stick cut in there. Matthews again. Zaitsev shot. That was blocked. A chance to break away here. Scheifele can't get away. Zaitsev caught him.
Jim Zaitsev, unbeknownst to him, just got his stick in the way of that, or else it would have been a breakaway.
Up the middle, Austin Matthews, stopped by Hutchinson. And back the other way, here's number two, Laine shoots, he scores! Hat-trick, game winner, Patrick Laine. As if it was meant to be, number one against number two. Number one draft pick gets a breakaway turn back. Number two wins the game on his.
And number one gets it first. And an excellent pass up the middle. Nylander again finds Matthews. Matthews tries to go five hole. Hutchinson, to his credit, stood his ground. Back the other way, two on one. Are you thinking pass? No way. And for Laine, one of the many great moments that I'm sure will happen in his career, but you couldn't have scripted it any better. Take the disappointment of draft day and throw it away. One or two, it's three goals there for Patrick Laine. What a moment for the young Jets superstar.
Four goals on the season, three of them tonight. The MTS Center littered with hats. Probably won't be the first time they'll have to give up a cap in Manitoba for Patrick Laine. What a game. What a finish. 4-0 Toronto, but a 5-4 win and a great comeback by the Winnipeg Jets. Sportsnet Central is now with Kenny DeMonca.